Hey fuckers, it's Friday.
I need you working.
Good night, folks.
Nailed it.
You are listening to your favorite podcast, Shoutcast Podcast, with your host, Bobby Skullface.
That's a solid unit, Mac.
Oscar and Jake.
I call it a rock friend.
Robert D.
So happy to be here.
The engineer, T2RX6.
It's a fit and finish.
Everyone's favorite internet troll, Greg for Mercy.
Only troll for good.
Meth Deluxe Baldwin.
Hell Hasbro.
And the most popular tattoo transformer fan ever, Decepticon.
Hey, ladies.
No, it's just awful.
Who's running that company?
I don't scale like that.
Upload complete, fuckers.
This podcast is intended for mature audiences only, and its sole purpose is to entertain. If it doesn't fit with your sensitive sensibilities, please feel free to turn it off now and...
Shut the fuck up, Chip.
Welcome to the wonderful world of Shattered TMNT Marvel Legends Cast Uncut, episode 136. I'm your shout-out to TCCA for banning me, host of Zefticon, and joining me tonight, we have the very articulate Robert D.
Oh, racist.
And I can move. I'm very articulated as well when I speak. Hey guys,
How many points of articulation are you?
Two.
My penis. Two. Just two.
All right. Next up, he is a talented toy reviewer, and he also rocks a mean beard. It's Justin T2RX6.
Yeah.
Bobby. Hey, Bobby's growing out a beard too.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. Where's Bobby's beard? What's going on?
It's gone.
What's happening, man? All right. He's also very talented, and he also has a beard. It's Hell Hasbro's own Matthew Deluxe Baldwin.
Yay. Hey there, everybody.
You brush your beard?
Yeah, I brush my beard. And I don't have a recorder on me for 24/7, so y'all could, you know, record everything I say, so y'all could probably put it on the show, so...
Do you put conditioner? Do you put some kind of beard product in that thing?
I put fruit, like berries and stuff.
Yeah. Balls?
Flowers.
Yeah. I try to. Some raspberries and, you know, whatever.
Dicks.
Nice. And lastly, his presidential run has been cut short after WikiLeaks stated he was selling plastic to Wei Zhong. It's Bobby's face.
I just want to let everybody know I'm going savage above and below, ladies. Mm. Oh, got the itchy phase, huh? Dude, it's so awesome. Like, I find myself that little, like I don't usually grow my facial hair, and like the little place where like the mustache comes down and meets like the beard is like a little bit longer than most of the other, and I find myself like twirling it all the time. I don't know. Yeah.
Beside train tracks, or
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Dynamite? Do you have dynamite in your hand or something?
When I had to shave it off. Mm. You can go as the Mandarin. You're a Mandarin.
Do you have to have a clean face to for your duty stuff?
He said duty. No.
So you can grow out a. That's cool. Why don't you?
No. It's a dress code thing at work.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, mine too, but I'm too lazy to shave.
Yeah. Wait. So if you had a beard, Lenny, would you have to wear like one of those beard face diapers?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I've been threatened with one before, and I'm like, it's okay, I guess I'll shave then. That's cool. But I don't have to wear a hairnet, so it's kind of a double standard. Whatever.
A racist.
You wear a hat?
Nope.
Not even a poofy hat?
No, not even a poofy hat.
Oh, I would.
Yeah. I just can't eat.
I wear one anyway.
I can't eat someplace that your chef doesn't have a poofy hat. Just can't have one.
Chef Priority.
All right. Did anybody get anything besides herpes? Robert D.
I got in Ghost Starscream. I got the MP. So he's nice. Yes, he's very nice. I showed you guys. I got the Constructicons Generation Toys in the background. Mm-hmm. I got DX9 Galvatron in his cannon mode, and he's pointing at the, I guess, already
demised ghost Starscream, who's standing there, like, what the fuck just happened to me? That's it.
I like it. I like it a lot.
That's a good figure.
Yeah, he's for the plastic. The plastic on that Starscream is so much weaker. You can just feel it than the Generation Toys Scrapper. Such a difference. You can really tell the difference. I'm never going to transform this thing again.
Hey, no. Greg's not here tonight. It's an open bash fest on Takara and Gigapower. Isn't Fans Toys awesome? Yeah. He's not here to defend them.
Fuck that Takara clear plastic.
Whoa. You still got me here. Hold on.
Come on. What's it Hasbro? He said Takara.
Hasbro never made a clear Starscream.
That is true, but Hasbro owns Takara. I think.
Yeah. And Greg actually has more of a leg to stand on with defending both those companies than you do defending Hasbro, and I think even you are aware of that.
Fuck you, Bobby.
All right, Matt, what'd you get this week?
I'm getting a new podcast.
Oh.
That's what I'm getting. Now, I forgot last week I mentioned I got Pretenders.
They're going to cover the big three, Mattel, Hasbro, and Parker Brothers.
So that's all right. Fuck you. Anyway, I got a G1 Pretender Landmine a couple weeks ago. I forgot to mention that last week. Nice. It's pretty cool. I love the Pretenders. And this week I picked up Wheelie, Titan Returns Wheelie. Pretty good figure for a little Titan for $10. He's everything you want.
No doubt.
He's got a lot of paint on him.
Just to cut you off here real quick, Matt, this is for Bobby. Oh, Hasbro owns Parker Brothers. So go ahead and delete that comment, whoever is writing that in.
How about Playmates? We'll throw there Playmates in there then.
That sounds good.
I will do whatever I want. I will just do a Marvel Legends podcast. Yeah, anyway, I know you'll be in. I know that. And Greg will be all three just talking about Marvel Legends. And Lenny, he does too. And I picked up Stripes.
I got a Daredevil.
I don't care. I have a Daredevil. I picked up Stripes. I did reviews on both of them. If you want to go check them out. He's the Steeljaw, which somebody, I guess, corrected me and said he's not supposed to be Steeljaw, but I think he does. I mean, whatever.
Doesn't he turn into a bird? Is that the one that turns into a bird?
No, that's not the bud. This is the tiger.
It's a tiger, or something.
I don't know. Well, anyway, watch it. It's the best floor time ever, so watch it. And I picked up a Marvel Select Thing. I saw him at a local comic shop, and he's heavy. He can knock out a little baby, so I like him.
I love that thing.
That's about it. Do you have him?
Yeah. I'm going to, because it looks like the Marvel Legends are going to put out a Fantastic Four here soon.
Yeah.
So
that'd be good. He's big enough, for.
I still plan on using, I'm sure Thing will be the Build-A-Figure or, like, some sort of exclusive or something.
Which are better, the Marvel Legends or Marvel Select?
Matters what you're looking for. Legends are more articulate, but the Select, some of them, like the bigger figures, are better for Marvel Select, like Hulk. Abomination, Thing, all that stuff. They're better suited for Marvel Select. I don't know. That's what I think, Bobby. I don't know. He may be something different.
Yeah. I think that Legends are highly articulated. Legends are also more completionist oriented. They make so many different characters. And they're slightly more affordable. And then the Select are higher grade sculpts, higher grade paint, and limited articulation. So it's just like
And they're also limited runs, right?
Yeah, because they only put like I don't know if they even do like waves. They kind of do waves, but if you find them, they're all different. Like Marvel Legends will put out, six or seven in a wave. Select will put out maybe two or three at the most. I don't know. But, you'll...
So do you have redundancy where you have a Build-A-Figure, like Thing, and then you have a Marvel Select Thing? Do you have stuff like that?
It could happen.
Yeah, it's personal preference, man. Like I like my Marvel Select Juggernaut more than I like my Build-A-Figure Juggernaut, just because I think it looks more impressive and it still kind of does the same job on my shelf.
Yeah.
You know, but it's you know, if somebody was like, no, I prefer the Legends, like I wouldn't debate it. I'd be like, nope, I get it. I totally get why.
Yeah, like there's Abomination Marvel Select and there's Abomination Build-A-Figure coming up. And so, I mean, it's just they're real beefy. I mean, they weigh a lot. The Thing and Hulk and all that shit, they weigh pretty good.
And the paint's superior on a Select usually.
Absolutely. Well, right? By leaps and bounds.
Yeah. I mean, the Marvel Select, what was it? Anti-Venom? Shits all over the
Oh, yeah.
But absolutely. But at the same time, the Hasbro one has more, like, it has elbow. I don't think the Select has elbow joints. It's just like.
Yeah, I don't think they have really good. It's not really good articulation at all.
Yeah.
For the Venom. But he looks good standing there.
I get the sense from you guys that the Marvel Legends stuff really doesn't stand well.
It depends. It's a case by case.
Okay.
What do you mean stand well? Like,
there's like two female. There's like three or four female molds now, and like two of them stand well, two of them don't. And the male figures pretty much stand okay, with the exception of like the Holson or Coulson mold. I said Holson. Listen to me.
What up, Holson?
Hello. Shout out to Holson.
Hello, Holson. But yeah, it's a case by case basis. Some stand better than others.
If you want to get those the poses, you know, if you're taking pictures and stuff and you want to get great poses out of stuff, you're gonna go with Marvel Legends, more than likely. But Marvel Select, if you want like the bigger figures, they're gonna look really, really great on your shelf with the Marvel Legends. I mean, they can coexist with each other. You know. Some of them, like Cable and some other ones are a little too big. Like Magneto, they're a little too big for like, you know, the bigger Marvel Legends or the smaller Marvel Legends. Yeah, but
it really pays off with the big characters and the monsters.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So, I don't know. They're a little too, I mean, Marvel Legends is about $20. Select, you're going to talk about, you can go average price about $25 to $28. Some of them go range higher.
There's so a toy shop in my neighborhood where it's $24.99 for all of them, each one, I mean. $24.99 across the board.
It's not bad. I get mine at Hastings, so. Okay, that's all I got.
Train station, Hastings.
Justin, what'd you get this week?
I'm gonna keep this nice and short. Not a goddamn thing.
Nothing.
Nice. All right, Bobby, how about you?
I got some stuff.
What'd you get to touch?
I got to touch. Ollie 2.1.
What?
Which is
and JJ?
Not,
JCC?
And JCC, which is not the version that we're getting. We're getting 2.2.
I don't buy that. I don't believe it.
Okay.
Well, I just want to say that may be true. 2.1 does not have any die cast. 2.2 is supposed to have the die cast. That's the word, anyway.
All that for Wheelie?
Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing, Matthew.
Just get the Titan Returns and call it a day.
What were your thoughts?
It's better. It's better. I'm gonna have the opportunity to look at it a little bit more in depth here soon. So I'll hopefully be able to give people a more rounder opinion, so to speak.
Is it? I need to transform my Ollie to put it back in the box to sell better.
It depends on how it's hard. It's hard to say, man, because it depends on how the die cast affects that figure.
Mm.
But I can tell you that it stands with no problem, and the legs move smoothly.
Yay!
Okay,
it's fine.
It's fine.
I got, let's see what the fuck else. I got a chance to look at Mega Man D Arts Vile and Mega Man X from, oh, I think I said that last week, didn't I? I got D Arts Mega Man. I got to look at D Arts Mega Man and D Arts Mega Man Zero. I got TFC Guy Hawk and finished the Lyokaiser set.
Oh, now you're saying the name.
Yeah. I got Make Toys, Cross Dimension, Striker Manus. I got
he looked pretty good. I have to say he looked pretty good.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he's a fun ass figure, man. It's not like it's not for my collection, but I wish it was. It's right. That type of thing.
The bot mode I got pretty good.
Yeah, definitely better than the truck mode.
Yes, it will be in
the truck mode. The truck mode is very like the emphasis of this line is it's painfully obvious. It's just to have the fun action figure element.
Right.
I got SH Figuarts Ant-Man, and I had I was also given a gift. I was given. I want to make sure I get the name right. Bandai's Metal
Bandai.
ARX-8. Leviathan, something like that. It's something, some Gundam type thing.
You got a Gundam? A
but it's a figure. It's not a model kit.
You got a metal build, style. Right? Yeah.
Yeah, it's badass. It's badass.
Not for me.
Not for
me. By the Tetra Jets. But
I mean, I definitely appreciate it. You know, I don't want anybody to get it twisted. Like it's probably perfect, actually. The toy. Okay.
Are you selling it?
No. I don't do that shit. If somebody gives me something, it's in my collection forever.
Is it office? Top shelf?
No,
office?
No, it's actually in the basement. It's in the basement. And then it's I
like
also
everybody.
Received a gift from Levi. I received these little homemade web shooting things that he made for Legends that can go on Spider-Man's wrists. He stopped by and dropped them off. So that was cool, and I got Crash Hog and Dump Truck or whatever they are.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say I got one more thing, man, but I can't recall
dump
at the moment.
Truck.
Shout out to Dust Mites. He let me borrow. Well, I borrowed it for good because I broke it. Spoilers.
Damn, again?
Yeah.
Robert Jr.
Bobby Brooks.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with me, man.
Robert Jr. Here going shit.
Mecha Form Sky Guardian, which was the
wow. That's gotta be the hardest. $170.
Was it $170? No way.
So.
No way. No way. No way.
Oh, that Jetfire? You touched that Jetfire?
Yeah,
he broke it.
Yep.
Did you wash your hands?
170.
Are you serious?
100%.
Oh my god. Dude, Dust was super cool about it too. It was
$170.
Yeah, we did. I was on the finger banging.
I'm gonna tell you right now, that thing isn't worth $50.
Wow.
I think it worth $20, dude.
It's
not anymore.
I told Dust I was gonna make it up to him, but now I gotta really make it up to him. But I want to give a special. I might have to. I'm not too proud.
With the skull face mask on, just
with the skull face mask on. I hit him up and I was like, man, it did not survive transformation. And he wrote me back and he was like, put it out of its misery.
Oh,
shovel.
So.
Legend. I just want you to know, Bobby, that Ace, you know, Ace Milo, he went through the whole transformation to not break it, and
I think Ace went from Jet to Robot, though. I'm just gonna put that out there.
Okay. Well, I was on, like I said, I was on the finger banging on the thing, and oh, that thing looks like.
Yeah, now you know what it is that it's
what part you break?
A hand. So the elbow. The elbow is. The way that, not the elbow, it's like the bicep. It's like where the elbow connects to the bicep. It looks like it should be a slider. Like it's like a T joint, like a T slide. And it looks like you would slide the piece on and off. But it actually,
it just snaps off.
No, you have to pop it off. You have to pop it out. So like the T sits there and you got to pull hard enough for it to unclip from it. And when I was doing it, it just I guess I had my palm on the hand of the figure, and it was enough, force to snap the hand off.
Was you reviewing it at the time?
Oh yeah, oh yeah. It's you'll see it in the transformation.
Did you go? Huh. Well.
All right. I can't wait. So anyway, I have something super special planned for the destruction of it. But that video won't be up this week.
It'll burn it with fire.
Now, let me tell you something. Burning it with fire is a step down from what I plan on doing to it.
Damn.
I'm gonna throw it off his roof.
Are you going to shit on it?
No, why do you always go to such a
what? That was extreme. Too far? Oh, yeah. Wait, okay. Okay, so Robert, whatever he says, it, okay, whatever.
Okay.
I got to
tell you that.
Okay.
That fans project, Shrapnel, was it? The hands that just fell off, that was funny as hell.
Yeah.
Oh, that wasn't his fault. You can see
I'm going through a slump right now, man. Like, I just.
You just touched it. Hand, like, flew off.
Yeah.
That wasn't your fault. I'll give you that one on that one. That was not your fault. That's fucked up.
The Sky Guardian one is definitely my fault. $170. Oh, my God. Dust, I am sorry. I mean, this sincerely. I'm going to. I told him, like, I had this. So I had this idea of what I'm going to do for him for a gift to make it up to him. But hearing that it's $170, he's getting more than that. I got it. Yeah.
Hand job.
Yeah, he's good. I owe him more than that, so I got.
I can't believe that shit was $170. God,
I got. I'll take care of him. Ugh.
I think you should blame Dustmice for fucking buying that shit for $170.
They have to be that expensive. They only sold two.
Dust got one. So bad. All right.
But here, one side note about that thing, like two super weird things about that toy. Number one. It comes with a little. It doesn't come with an instruction manual. It comes with a little.
Oh, the video.
It's a little piece of paper that's like cut, and it's like an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper that was cut like in half, so they could put one in two boxes from one piece of paper.
Wow!
It just has a YouTube link to go to the channel.
Yeah.
To
watch the they were talking about that shit.
Monetize that shit.
But I don't even know if it's monetized.
You get an extra couple pennies for everybody who needs to see how to transport this.
and then here's
the two people that bought it.
Here's the other thing, is the hand. This shit is the weirdest shit I've ever seen. The hand. Okay, so it's like a sculpt of a hand, with the four fingers. The four fingers have a base pen knuckle, and then a second knuckle pen. So they articulated the fingers in two places. And then, where, like, the meat of the hand is a 5mm port. So you plug the weapon into the port, and then you wrap the fingers around the port. And that's how he holds his weapon.
Genius. Looks like he's holding a fist, basically. That's all he's holding.
It's
a fist.
Yeah. It's so strange. And then the face looks like some monster. I can't remember. Like, it's some old lady monster, like some troll. Monster. But like I can't.
I'm actually looking at looking on Google Images now, and everyone's comparing it to Nicolas Cage's face. So
yeah, but there's another face out there. It's like this old woman. I can see it in my head, like an old woman from like a fantasy film. But I
those
can't.
Shoulders were weird too.
It's so bad. Anyway, okay.
But by the way, I did get something this week. I just remembered.
So. What'd you get?
What'd you get?
I got the Shapeways fix kit for Omnigonic Spinout, and it fixes none of the problems.
Yes. All right, I saw that. I saw your video.
Well, yeah. Well worth the $16 it cost. So.
So what is the piece or pieces?
It locks the chest in, and it does lock the chest in a little bit nicer, but it doesn't address any of the other issues of like loose pieces like the neck piece and stuff like that. It does have like this interesting shoulder kit that gives him a better quote-unquote better range of motion on his shoulders, and I don't know, I don't think it looks good because you still have the little yellow pieces still like straight up and down, but you can't install the piece without permanently modifying the toy basically. But like you really couldn't install the other piece without permanently modifying the toy because it wasn't really sized right. And as you're installing the piece that locks other pieces in, you're starting to see the errors of the toy's design as the screws are just falling out all over it. So you just have to kind of glue everything back together. And so it's basically both permanent modifications to the toys. It's pretty awesome. So.
Bryce.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you glue his foot together, his left foot?
No.
Because that thing falls. That was falling apart on me, I remember.
Yeah, I don't think the foot. I don't think I had a problem with the foot. I know the wheel fell off randomly. You know, that was cool. But,
so much of that mold doesn't even snap together. It's just held together by wishes.
Pretty much. So, like I said on the little review
wish factor
piece, like by this point, he's pretty much more clear nail polish than he is plastic anymore. Like that's how much is holding him in various positions. But whatever.
Look good. Look like you tightened him up well, nicely.
Oh, yeah. He doesn't wobble anymore.
Tighten his
ass
up.
He stands like a champ.
Mm, like a wish factor. Hey, Lenny, what'd you get?
I got nothing.
Shit.
It's the best type of thing to get.
Yeah.
Also, like, I want to shout out to the Realm of Collectors early on.
Honorable mentions?
I was at NJCC this Sunday and saw all those guys, and they showed a lot of love. And actually, shout out to Energon Addict. He brought, like, a little gift for Leia. Like, and it's cool. Like, it's like a little, like, stocking cap that's got the buns, like the Leia buns on the side.
That's cool.
And, like, a little onesie that says Stormtrooper and, like, a little book. But, like, in my it's actually pretty accurate, though, because this kid shits all. I mean, like, I've never seen. This is my third baby. I've never seen anything like this. Like, this is, like, It's like she's, you know, she's, God bless her.
So you're having a shitty time, basically.
I mean, I'm telling you, man, like, it's like.
Thank you, Matt.
There was a while there where it was like maybe 2 to 3 times an hour.
Oh.
Yeah. Just insanity.
That's I got that beat.
But anyway, they showed me a ton of love and like seeing him. And then, Hung was there from 215, and I got to kick it with him for a while. It's a funny motherfucker, man. And JR came up there with me, and so Tyler was there from Toy Detox. And I tell you what, I don't know. I think that New York lifestyle is rubbing off on Tyler a little bit. He was a little slicker this time than the last time I saw him up there.
Did he get gangster on you?
Really?
Did he pull
He's like, not gangster, just like a little, like you know, he had a little city slickness to him.
Really?
Hell yeah. Like, I was like, look at you, man. You're looking.
Hey, when he walked in, was it really bright?
No. He actually he walked in. I mean, he had like a fresh black tee on, and he was looking like you should have seen
that.
Him.
Fat Joe?
Was it like, well, if it was really tight, maybe that's the New Jersey rubbing off on.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't really tight. It was like a respectable t-shirt for an adult man. And I said, I told him, I was like, look, man, I think this city lifestyle is like all that Utah shit or wherever the fuck he was in Nevada. That shit is gone.
Utah, Nevada, wait, same thing.
Tyler was same wearing thing. A black shirt.
Did it have Biggie on it?
Like, no. It's just like had a slickness. No. He had an air about him. He had a little slick air about him.
But Tyler in a black shirt's like a fucking walking yin yang. No,
that is true. But was he wearing a pair of Jordans? Was he rocking?
Oh,
Jordans?
You know, I didn't even. Domino. As a man that takes a lot of pride in his shoes, I didn't even give him the honor of checking their
he
shoes out.
He would kill you if you stepped on his shoes.
Yeah.
But look, I'll tell you, old Tyler may have killed you. New Tyler will have somebody kill you.
Nice.
You had body parts? New Tyler is a boss.
Mm.
Yeah. Oh, I got something I forgot about. I know you guys aren't going to care at all.
Syphilis.
But I got the diecast faction symbols for my MPP-10 Nemesis and MPP-10 Ultra Magnus.
Oh, good job.
Sure. All right. Yeah, we don't talk about knockoffs on this fucking show, Jackass.
It's a debatable issue.
Because I listened to End of the Realm this morning, and they were talking about J. Rue's little shorts. And
tat rolled shorts.
And what's funny is I almost went in on him, like when he first came up. You know, I gave him a 5 and said hello and everything. But then I saw them shorts. Now it wasn't the short. It was like they were a little on the fitted side, but it was the fact that they were rolled up at the bottom. I almost went in on him, but I was like, no, let's just be.
Did it make you want to go to the skating rink, man?
And J. Rue was a good dude. I didn't know. He looked like he was in good spirits. I didn't want to fuck with him.
You didn't hug him, give him a shocker.
No? Oh, I hugged him all right. I gave him some
give him little Give a little goose. No.
I have to update my. Did I get anything? My mailman just came. Because it's morning time here.
Live.
Live.
I just got Striker Menace from Make Toys.
Nice.
Yeah, boy.
Now spend the rest of the show opening them up on air and being really upset.
We'll do a figure banging live.
Wait, which one is he?
What?
Which one is he?
Striker Menace?
Yeah. I don't know the names, man. There's so many fucking third party
new Make Toys Optimus Prime.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, whatever. Good job, man.
Very cool. All right. Let's do some show. We have movie show news. We have images, I'm guessing, of Barricade. Yay. I got it. Wait. Before you think I'm writing this off, Matt, Barricade is actually my favorite Transformer from the Bayverse, just so you know.
Is it?
That's cool.
Yeah.
He's got a mask. He's got a bunch of cool stuff. He's got a nightstick and some handcuffs and some other stuff.
What?
He's
a nice trick.
Yeah. He's got a little nightstick going on. Isn't that what that yellow thing is?
He's got a nightstick.
Nightstick.
And he's got a.
I'm not sure why he has brass knuckles, though. I don't like that.
I don't like the pistol. Fact that he looks nothing like the original character. I don't know. He was fine as he is, and now everything about him is different, and I don't think that he looks interesting.
He looks kind of like him into a police car version of Bumblebee.
Yeah, and have you seen Pacific Rim? He looks like one of those robots. You know, it's just I don't know.
I think he looks like Monkey Prime.
I can see that too.
I like the fact that the words on his brass knuckles are in reverse. Then when he punches you, they're spelled properly. Is pretty cool. I like that.
Mm.
I like it.
Is this his personality?
What?
It says douchebag.
Duplicious? Or duplicious?
Duplicious. He is duplicious.
It says Fergalicious.
I've never seen that word before.
Where is this?
I'm gonna have to get a thesaurus fucking around with these guys.
Duplicitous
Decepticon Sentry.
You're so evil, you're duplicious, honey.
Hi.
What does that word mean, Robert?
Your bad tastes good.
What does that word mean, Robert?
Duplicitous?
Yeah.
I think it means backstabbing. I think so. Perhaps.
What the hell did you make it $10?
Where's Philip? Philip! Wrong shirt, though. You guys are slaving that guy. Philip!
Deceitful.
Deceitful. Why didn't they just say that?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, he's a Decepticon. They already did say it.
His history is to punish and enslave. Or...
<It's a lie>.
Conspicuously die in the first movie and then not come back for four movies.
No, he's in the third one.
Was he?
Yeah, he was in the scene. He was when they captured all the Autobots, and he was down there with Soundwave and stuff.
You're right. I forgot all about that.
You might have missed it. It was the scene where you have in the epileptic episode.
It was probably because I was looking for this magnificent piece of robot here, and I just couldn't see him. So
you're a magnificent piece of robot.
Mm-hmm. You know what? Do you see his Decepticon logo anywhere on him?
I have to open the link again now.
Hey, I think I've heard he might be Prowl. Okay, I mean, I don't know. I mean, this could be he could be
You're thinking Hasbro already.
Well, I'm just saying, he could have switched sides and he may, be Prowl. This may not be even Barricade.
But it says Barricade.
They could just have.
Well, it does, but it could not be Barricade. It could be Prowl. Man, fuck this. I don't care. Whatever.
Neither do the people who make this movie. So, welcome
to
the team.
Yes, I do, Justin. I don't care.
People love his arm cannon. Do you like the arm cannon, Matt?
I do. I like it. I think it looks good. I can't wait for the toy.
When you got an arm cannon like that, what?
Predator?
No, Monkey Prime.
Oh, I thought you were talking the Megatron Predator face because he's got an arm.
Cannon.
Oh, that's coming up.
Barrett. Same with Barricade, but that kind of arm cannon, you better keep your hand in a fist while you're shooting because you're going to lose some fingers. I mean, it's just all around your hand.
I can say that it looks like they're transitioning the robots from shards of metal to more Pacific Rim robots. Slick. Like I said, like they're more, they're getting increasingly more humanoid looking, so to speak.
Yeah, I agree.
Is that a bad thing?
It kind of is, in my opinion, because like if you're gonna go one way with it, stick with it. Like, if you're going to try to make them more humanoid, then, like, just redo the whole thing. Like, because you've now
hadn't
taken...
Yeah, but haven't been on Earth for a while?
Yes, but, like, since when has that dictated the robot mode? It dictates the alt modes. We've seen that before, but, like, I don't know.
This is also Bayverse.
It's not G1.
I guess. I mean, for all we know, this isn't even Barricade as Barricade. It's Barricade as the same thing that Galvatron Megatron was the... whatever thing, but like I don't know, I just feel like you've taken recognizable characters and you're just now for whatever reason changing how they look, probably to sell toys. That's probably the ultimate reason.
I was gonna say, yeah, they have to sell toys because they can't put out the original again to try to
is there a theory that they're travel back in time and it's kind of like a rehashing of that original time travel episode where they go to Camelot or whatever? I mean, could that be what's going on here, and that's why they're looking humanoid with armor and all this shit?
I mean, well, there's definitely going to be, like, because they were talking about bringing in knights to the round table and all that shit, so who knows?
Fucking police car.
King Arthur and the sword in the stone. And...
What you don't realize is it's King Arthur, Witwicky.
I fucking hope so.
Arthur Witwicky.
I ruined it for you all.
You can go see it.
Or I did it amazing.
He becomes best buds with Bumblebee. Oh, God.
And he's like, sir.
I'll see y'all at the theaters.
All right, you know what else we're going to see at the theaters? Ultron.
Nothing.
Yeah, it does have an Ultron. It looks like a Predator and Ultron love child.
It's just a mask. He'll take it off.
He looks less tough with his tusks open. Very 70s kind of hairdo going on.
I like how Megatron looks like fusion cannons don't work. Let's make incredibly big maces.
Well, he's got a little cannon this time.
I suppose, or it's a shield. He'll probably never fire anything. It'll just be a shield.
My question for this is, why is peace through tyranny? Is that a personality?
Yes. If you've noticed, all their personalities have been words. Not actual personality traits, just words.
Dude, so this Friday at the bar, I'm going to bring Sasha. You're going to love her, dude. Her personality totally peace through tyranny.
You know what, though? You know what? That describes some girls. I'm just saying.
Yeah. That describes a lot of women.
Shout out to Sunswipe5, who said, I'm going with alt mode is that dragon. I can see dragon imagery in this robot mode, and I agree. I think that he's going
to be a
dragon.
And King Arthur Witwicky's going to have to fight a dragon.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Yep.
You know what? Even if King Arthur is in this movie and they never say Witwicky, he's fucking King Arthur Witwicky now. So.
Megatron looks so awesome. Love that he evokes a barbarian medieval tyrant in his design. Also had a feeling that his face, as we've seen it before, evoked a battle mask, and it works.
What are some of the other characters we've had in King Arthur's time? Lancelot Yeager?
Merlin.
There we go. Merlin Yeager. Merlin Yeager. Love it.
Let's see what else. Holy crap, an arm cannon, an actual identifiable referential element. God, man, there's a lot of smart motherfuckers online today. Only,
that is true. This is the first time he's actually had something on his arm looking like a cannon.
Yeah, I agree.
Didn't even think about that.
All right, that's enough about that.
Do you think he's going to actually transform or just be transformium bullshit. Not that his transformation isn't bullshit anyway, the way they do it, but
I think
it's going to be that weak.
I think they're just going to write out the transformium and it, like, with no explanation. It's just never to be heard of again.
Yeah. What do you mean transformium? What's up?
Exactly.
Unless they fucking team up with Morgan Le Fay and Merlin's with the Autobots and he casts the magic spell on everyone. Oh, God. That's going to happen.
Cast the magic spell on everyone.
It's going to fucking lightning bolt. Lightning bolt. It's going to fucking happen. I would watch it for that. Oh, God.
All right. Lastly, we have Yellow Bastard. Open. I'm guessing this is Bumblebee. Now look at that. His face mask looks more like a bee this time, or a wasp, or something.
Hope the toy gets the mask face.
Yeah, then we can paint it green and call it Waspinator.
It's just a photo, but it looks like his wings are on his chest in front of his face.
This looks like... This looks par for the course, though. I don't feel like this is anything outside of the norm. Like that. Yeah.
Why the fuck would you make a scout your second in command, though? That makes no sense to me.
Because toys.
Mm.
At least he's yellow. At least we get some color.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Matt, you like this one too, Matt?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Matt, what's your favorite so far out of what you've seen of the upcoming movie?
What do you mean, like the favorite? Oh, my favorite.
Pizza.
I don't know. I haven't really picked one yet. I mean, I like them all.
Do you, you don't think anyone, like, between what we've seen so far, which do you like, the Megatron, the Bumblebee, or the Barricade?
The Barricade looks pretty good.
Are you butthurt?
No, I'm not butthurt.
Look at these alt modes. I think he did this next link.
I think Bumblebee's got some female-looking proportions on him. I don't know if anybody's noticed how skinny his waist is there.
Hips.
But he's making Barbie jealous looking there. That's all I'm going to say.
So apparently the fourth picture down. Oh, yeah, I see it. We've got some pixelation.
Yep.
That's definitely a penis.
I feel like this should be Matt's segment and he's not even talking. Fuck.
There's no point.
Defend it.
I like
Matt.
The Camaro.
What?
The Camaro. No, there's no point in defending it.
I
want
to hear your thoughts.
I give up, man. No, I'm good. I like the Camaro. It looks really nice. I wish I could get one.
You don't defend it. Talk about what you like about it.
Have we seen this Benz truck? This Mercedes truck?
Yeah, that's Retgar, I think, isn't it? Oh, no, sorry, that's a...
No, it's Bulkhead. I mean, Bulkhead. Hound.
Hound, yeah.
I've got a question for Justin. Why does Bumblebee's side mirrors not have a mirror in it? Is that some kind of new car thing?
It's fucking stupid. That's why.
Yeah. All right, cool.
Yeah. Actually, you know what?
Did you see that?
I don't know why. Honestly, I have no clue why it would be, but I assume it's because they think it looks cool, and I just really hate what they've done with the car. I think it looks awful.
I love it.
Terrible.
I love it. Did you see this little thing? He's got the dead, three dead Autobots and two dead people on his onslaught on his vehicle somewhere, I'm guessing. That's pretty cool.
I'm
looking at all the gun bumper stickers on it. You like those, Matt?
Yep.
That's as close as Australian can get to it.
Yeah.
If you heard the shot, I missed.
If you can read this, it's too late.
Are these all on Hound, who's supposedly the medic?
It looks it.
Yes.
I mean, like... Don't get me wrong, I have no problem with it being on Hound, but when you slap the symbols on him to, clearly identify him as the medic, it just doesn't make sense. So, favor.
Hey, Matt, let me ask you this, because you're in the Army. Do the medics carry sidearms or no?
Yeah. I mean, they carried pistols. They were mostly, what is it? I mean, they could, you know, yeah, I mean, if they carried anything, it would be a pistol. I mean, they really couldn't carry an M16 or anything like that. They were mainly like the officers, you know, a lot of the officers carried pistols back in the day. I never saw wartime, so I don't know for sure. So, I think they just carried pistols.
I just watched Lone Survivor last night. Holy shit.
Oh, Mark and Mark?
What's that? Yeah. It's like it's based on a book. This Navy SEAL team in Afghanistan, they were trying to pull off like an assassination of some high-ranking Taliban leader. And long story short, these like goat shepherds were like walking through the mountains, and they came across these SEALs. The SEALs detained them, and it was like two kids and an old man, and they had like this moral dilemma of like, do we kill him, or do we let him go, or what do we do? And they decided to let him go and view the mission as being compromised and just get out of there. But like one of the kids, like according to the movie, like ran, like took off, and then like before they knew it, they were like under attack by like this, basically this Taliban regiment, and killed all of them but one. Like only one American survived.
It's a pretty good movie.
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude. I was like, I was definitely like in it. You know what I mean? Like I was getting anxious, and I was on the edge of my seat, so to speak.
I saw a movie this weekend.
What's that?
Ice Age Collision Course. Oh my fucking god. It's my life now, and that's like I look forward to it. That's how sorry my life is right now.
I gotta take Jana to the movies this week. It's her last week before school starts, and plus, you know, I always fuck with her. This is my favorite week, so like every time I see her in the morning, I just start going, it's the most wonderful time of the year. She gets so upset. Anyway,
you enjoying your time off?
You know what? I have been. We got the house cleaned. Got like, you know, I got everything dusted downstairs. It's just I'm in a good
You dusted
spot.
Your collection?
Yep.
The whole thing?
Yep.
How long did that take?
Long ass time.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for dusting my Optimus Primal. I appreciate it.
Did it arrive safely?
Yes, it did. He's in my office hanging out with me.
All right. Do we want to look at this last?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm playing with my toy. We've done that one.
Me too.
Kind of late for this one. Something Hasbro, something.
Hasbro applies for the Transformers live action movie trademark. With the 10th anniversary of Transformers 2007 just around the corner, Hasbro has applied for the trademark rights for Transformers under live action movies. What's interesting is that as a proof of usage, Hasbro has submitted a screenshot of the IMDb page of Transformers 2007 along with their trademark application to the United States Patent and Trademark Office. Justin, decline them.
I have no say in that. Sorry. Can't do it. So. Here.
And then it has the details.
Yeah, but couldn't you, like, isn't there, like, water cooler talk? Don't you know the guy that'll be considering the application?
I do not.
You could just, like, you know, subliminally affect him?
Nope, I don't.
Yes, He does.
But the, you know, the trademark thing we could bring up in a discussion towards the end. That'll be something.
Yeah.
The donut table? Anything? No?
Hey, my donut table is in my house. I don't know if you realize that or not, but I work from home now. So, like, your dress code that you were talking about earlier, like, my dress code, pants are optional, you know, all that stuff. It's pretty laid back in my place of work
It's pretty awesome.
It's cool. When's Adele due? I mean, Bedell. When's Bedell due?
Bedell is due in October, so towards the end. So coming up, like 10 weeks or something like that.
Nice.
Yeah, right. It's coming up.
All right, I'm going to stop playing with that. All right. We have third party news. Yeah, we've got Unique Toys Alan. I'm pretty interested to see what you all think of this. I love it.
Except Do you?
Yeah, I'm down for this one.
Damn. Dude, you like the...
I like those Unique big toys. Feet. I like big see, feet.
You like the Unique Toys DX9 look in general, I feel like.
Not always, but yeah.
I am not feeling this. I feel like this looks... I feel like somebody sent me a picture of this... Like when it right when it was like the day it went up, and I just responded, I was like, I just said, this is gonna look great on my manga shelf. It's just, it looks very anime to me.
Yeah, it does. But I dig that. I mean, that's what I dig about the Make Toy stuff. And
yeah, but I feel like they're I feel like this looks cartoony anime. I don't know. I don't like.
I think
it.
It's
but
the chest. The chest is a little rounded instead of. It's and the calves. Crotch area, the crotch area is a little big. It looks like a diaper. Yeah.
See, he didn't look like this in the cartoon. Even his legs weren't like that. You know, they weren't that just bulky and big.
Well, I don't think he means cartoon like the movie and the after that season three. But he looks. Yeah, he just looks cartoonish. I mean, I can understand the feet, but like I said, when I posted it, I think I said people are going to probably like this, but. The chest is not right. I don't think it's more rounded than more blocky than what the toy and the cartoon had. And he just looks, you know, like I said, the crotch area he looks like he's wearing a diaper. The feet, yeah, I can understand the feet. I mean, it's really cool. It looks nice. I mean, I like the alt molds, the helicopter and the whatever that thing is. I think they hit both of them right. But, that bot mode, I don't know. It's unique as toys. I mean, you know, it's unique toys. I mean, you can tell it's unique toys, but...
It's definitely unique. Those legs are... Look at them compared to...
it's clean on the back, though.
Yeah, it's clean. Yep.
It's clean.
It's clean on the front, too. I mean, it's a clean toy.
He looks too smooth. He looks too smooth, like he's got, like, a lotion on him or something.
And he pulls off the alt modes pretty well, I feel like.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, he does. Definitely. Yeah, he does do that. I like it. I like toys. I think I'll get it.
It's like when you're like basing a design, I feel like off of Springer, so much of you know the depiction, the way he you know his drawings, they're so they are just so rounded and like dumpy, you know. And but there are other shots where he looks more robotic, so I can see where maybe they just went off the wrong fucking screenshot and went just a little too. It's like they wrote Transformers in bubble letters or something, you know. It's just like bubbly. It's just too rounded.
I like his size too.
I don't like the yellow feet either.
I've seen another picture come out, and I think it was from Unique Toys. And they've shown it with it has gray feet with like a couple of yellow headlights so that you still get the yellow on the alt mode.
Okay.
He looks like they have a picture of him next to Ryan.
Oh yeah, the picture's here. Yeah. So I don't know if that's
he don't look like he's gonna be too much too difficult like Sandstorm was. I don't think he's gonna be difficult to transform like he
was. Dude. Shout out to Orion 2703, who commented down at the bottom, and look what he wrote.
Wait,
what do you say?
A lot of scrolling.
I want you guys to see it because I don't want to.
Ah,
yeah.
Nice.
He wrote feet. Feet. Those are some seriously enormous legs, which may throw the figure off badly. It looks promising, but I want to see the fans' toys one as well at this point.
Yeah, shout out to Orion 2703. He's even got a Neuro Rex as his profile picture. So, very elite of you. I like it.
Very elite of you.
How much is he? I think they've already put the pre-orders up for him, wasn't they?
They certainly did. I think it was
How much was it?
$130, I think. Yeah, if Asian retail, $99, I think, and then $130 for you guys.
Because that Blur is really tall, and he's a good two heads taller than him.
Speaking of pre-orders, Justin, did your Psycho hit?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't wait to do that review, brother.
It's going to be good, even though he's going to be tiny as shit.
Yeah, but no, what I'm saying, like, because we're gonna go hardcore with the with the ignoring of Machine Robo.
Yeah, I gotta get that thing shipped because I need to do my GoBots review. So, yeah,
we should try to get it out like on the same week.
Like, just really piss everybody off.
Yeah. So yeah, I see they his fucking feet are yellow, I think, because it's supposed to be his fucking headlights and his pontoons. So that's why they're fucking yellow.
Yeah.
My problem, I think he looks fine. He's a little bit too bulky. I feel like Springer was not this, like, chunky looking.
Yeah.
But I also have just a big problem with the size. Like, I guess he looks okay next to that, the old MP Rodimus or whatever, which I think is in the Rodimus mode. I'm not really sure. I don't know. I just, for me, like, Springer shouldn't be the same exact size as Rodimus, and that's what kind of kills me on this thing. Like, I want him to be MP Ironhide size. Like, that's the size Springer I'm looking for. And, like, that's why I didn't buy into, like, if he was probably about the size of this Blur, and Blur was smaller to the size of the MP Hot Rod toy, I think I'd be all in. But just too big. I don't know. Doesn't do anything for me. And the sad thing is, like, with fans toy scale, like with the headmasters and stuff, like, I'm not even certain that they are gonna produce something that's the size I want it to be either. So I don't know. I'm stuck without a Springer, I guess.
I'm sure someone else will come along next week and announce theirs.
Maybe.
It's fine.
Well, what do you think about
three Springers coming?
That
I got Toy World.
Yes.
Sure. That's gonna be the sure winner of all of them.
So
thank you to Toy World.
I mean, you saw the comparison with the Digibash fans toys, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think the fans toys looks still off the mark as well?
I think the fans toys looks like a toy and the cartoon.
I think he's asking Justin. I think. I don't know.
Oh, I'm not sure if I've
any
seen
of
it.
You.
I'm not sure if I've seen it to answer, to be honest.
I like the fans toys Springer.
Let me take a look.
Yeah, of course you do. Fans toys apologist.
I know. Sorry.
The fans toys looks like the toy and the cartoon. I think a good mixture of it.
I'm waiting for Ocular Max.
No, you'll be waiting for a while.
For me with the fans toys ones, I'm not sure. Like, I think the all modes look good, but I don't know about the robot mode. Yeah, I don't know. If he's sized right, then he'll probably be okay, but he's probably not gonna be, so it's okay too, I guess. It's depressing. Man, fuck Springer.
I actually see how big. Got some Springer picks up there. I don't think Springer is supposed to be pretty big. But what do I know?
Yeah, I mean, in some people, Springer's going to be fine, and there's probably going to be someone commenting, like, oh, in this picture, he's this size, and I know there's probably pictures next to him next to Rodimus, you know, that would prove that his size is fine, but that's just, in my personal opinion, I don't think he should be sized that way, and that's just how I like him to be, you know, so.
Right.
Well, that episode, he was as tall as Rodimus. And then the next week he wasn't. So.
Exactly.
He's taller here, though. That's the problem, I think.
It is pretty big. Rodimus's head goes up to his nose. You know?
Like, I feel like if the scale was still the original MP01 scale, which that the Hot Rod version of that MP09 toy fits that original MP01 scale. If that was the case, I'd be completely happy with this guy. But it's not, so...
Sounds like you need an MPP-10 in your life.
No, I don't need that. And you know what else I don't need? I saw that there's pre-orders for the oversized Sideswipe, and I just don't understand anybody
who
needs
crap.
MP10 Sideswipe.
He's like, what are you doing down there, Prom?
Wait a goddamn minute. Now, why is that stupid, Robert? I don't know. You know, maybe if I loved Sideswipe, I could see, like, hey, I want a giant fucking Sideswipe. But, I mean, I like having a giant prime, a really perfect, perfected giant prime.
I mean, but it scales with that prime. Like, if somebody wanted to go that route.
Yeah, I'm not. I mean, I didn't get the MPP 10 to start a new whole scale.
I know you didn't, but I'm saying, like, I don't understand how you can validate one and invalidate the other.
Not to each his own, but for myself, you idiot. My plan wasn't to get like a whole new set to go with the MPP 10. It's more of a novelty.
No, I get that. I get that, but I don't understand why that's stupid.
I don't know, because I think Sideswipe looks fucking retarded that big. I don't know. Prime, it's like, for some reason, he's in a pup, you know, but Sideswipe, like, you're a fucking idiot. You're too big. Fucking idiot.
I hope they do an Ironhide that size. I'm just going to have the giant hip skirts. I'm just going to take them off and hang them on my wall, like wall art.
They will.
If they did, what if Wei Zhang took the MP Ironhide and actually perfected it, and they fixed the proportions of the chest and his sides, which you still wouldn't get.
No, not. It's in the scale that I want.
Probably wouldn't be the.
Yeah, if it was upsized. If it was upsized, then no. I don't. What am I gonna do with it? You know what I mean? Just have a huge iron eye.
Put it next to your Sideswipe. Your oversized Sideswipe.
I'm not getting that shit either. I just don't understand how you can like validate one and invalidate the other. Like MPP 10 is cool. MPP Sideswipe, stupid.
I don't know. It's just what I'm thinking in my head.
All right. So
this is something in G3. Springer's almost tall as Ultra Magnus in the movie, in certain shots.
I don't like that because he's at his core. His one transformation is a car, and he shouldn't be. You know, like just like Blur should not be as big as Prime. I really don't think so. Like, I don't know. Should just be Hot Rod size. He really should be.
In that picture, Cup is bigger than both of them.
Cup is further in, though.
Wait a second. Now I gotta go see this picture.
Is the original MP Rodimus the same height as Carrie? I can't remember because I sold mine.
He's roughly the same.
Yeah, roughly the same.
I'm just trying to figure out because I'm okay with Springer being the exact same height as Rodimus, but I don't think he should be taller.
No, Carrie's a little smaller though. His face, his head's smaller. He's a little, his features are.
I just don't get him. Shit.
But I want to get it, Matt.
No, me and you can get it.
Okay, cool.
So, okay, who's in on this?
I am.
Me and Matt.
I like unique toys. They're good. They put out some good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Two. I don't know, man. That Blur just doesn't do it for me. So you getting them?
I like the blur.
That's the one thing by them that I can say I really genuinely like.
That blur is too, that blur for me is on par with Fans Toys Tesla, where it's like a great toy, but it's just like dead. It has no soul. You know.
That's stupid, Robert.
The thing I don't get with unique toys and. They've done three triple changes now. Is that right? They've done Octane, they've done Sandstorm, and now Springer.
Yep.
And I don't feel like any of them really scale together.
And I don't feel like any of them really look like they belong in the same line.
Right. That's the problem I have with it.
And you add Blitzwing into it. I mean, I know it's DX9, but you add Blitzwing into it, and that looks like it's a different line also.
I think that Blitzwing would probably match up with this Springer pretty well, though.
Maybe.
But that's as far as I would go with that. I don't think Octane or Sandstorm at all.
The only thing that was just weird on this one is to me is the chest.
Yeah.
Is that right?
No, I was hoping it was gonna be though. Like as soon as you said the only thing that's weird to me, in my head, like my fingers crossed. I'm saying, come on, say something awesome. Say something awesome.
But the chest is just I don't know. The chest doesn't look like anything. Like it's not. From the cartoon, it's not from the toy. So
it's funny you say that because people have been photoshopping this chest onto the Fans Toys one.
Really?
Yeah, I think this chest looks more toon accurate than the Fans Toys one. But the Digibash on the Fans Toys one, it like used the paint to make the chest appear more.
In the cartoon, he's got the box chest. This one's kind of rounded. The UT chest has, it doesn't look like anything. I mean, nothing that Springer does, but whatever. That's just me.
That was
potato, stupid. Potato. You're stupid.
Yeah,
I am.
Your penis is stupid.
Fans Toy Springer, and that looks like.
Yeah, the Fans Toy Springer, the chest looks perfect. It looks.
No, it doesn't look perfect. It is
no, it doesn't.
It's kind of no, no it doesn't. It doesn't. Mm-hmm. It's kind of the wrong shape, but I think overall it just looks more impressive.
It has to look like a scoop more than
it has a scoop shape. It has a stronger presence about it. I don't know.
All right. Speaking of presence, we have Despotron colored test shots.
Yeah. This actually, let's talk about this, and then I have a question to raise to you guys. Something that I heard this week that was pretty interesting about Megatron in terms of toys. But this looks good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He's thick. I like his thickness.
Got an ab crunch.
Yep.
I think his lower legs are too wide. And I don't like his head sculpt. His face. His head.
I don't mind the lower legs. I see what you mean with the face, but like the... I'm trying to look.
Kind of looks like he got hit in the face with a mallet or something.
But like some pictures, I feel like I see that. And then some pictures I feel like look better.
Which face are you talking about, though?
The girl?
This is fucking head. Like
Is it too skinny?
You're talking the helmet, then? Or
I think it's the helmet. I think it might be the lighting and the angles, because it looks kind of flat. It looks a little too flat in front.
Like I think the face looks good.
I can see what you're saying, Robert. It does look like the top, like the forehead part is like crushed in or something almost.
Yeah, like almost like it should come up a little bit more.
Yeah, like it's just too angled taller. Or something. Yeah.
But then you see it from different angles and it looks fine. So.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I think if you're looking like right below it, or like if you're looking up at it, I think it looks better. I like the face sculpt itself. I'm not talking about the dome, his helmet. But the face sculpt looks... You know, the Gurr ones look pretty good.
There's too much line work on it. I think maybe there's just too much line work on it. If you look, they have some cuts in there that I'm not accustomed to.
The articulation is pretty impressive.
It's a little stylized.
Yeah.
You know,
the articulation looks good.
I was looking at some reviews of the DX9 Mitron, like the big one.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I kind of want to check him out. Like, I don't know. I'm not sure I dislike him like that much more than, you know, this MMC one. Like, it's hard for me to pick, actually. Like, I'm starting to look at the two of them, and like some of the proportions that Mitron has, like, I like the big beefy look of this guy, but I kind of think I like the looks of the DX9 one with respect to the cartoon better. So I don't know.
It looks like the DX9 one's a little taller as well.
Yeah,
because this guy is on par with Apollyon in terms of height. I mean, it's negligible, really.
Well, they're a lot closer in size, like by the Sumbo chart. Like Megatron is not that much taller than Prime by the Sumbo chart.
Mm-hmm.
You know what bothers me about this guy? What really bothers me about this figure is that giant blue circle. It looks like he ate R2-D2. It's just a little too big. A little too
hard. Do y'all think do y'all think the kind of where he's bending at the knees, where, you know, the poses, you know, it's kind of long. It kind of looks like the Titan Returns blaster and Soundwave in the front. I mean, I understand why, because it's the handle and everything, but that's a long knee.
Yeah, I can see that.
The knees on. Yeah.
I mean, it's just a big, it's a big hole, a big gap down there. Now, when he's standing up, you know, just, you know, not bending, it looks good. But I think when it bends, man, it looks really, it's just long.
Yeah, Hardhead had that same problem. When you bend the knees, you ended up.
It looks like you might have to. It looks like you got to cheat. You got to open up flaps to get his knees to bend.
You think so?
Oh, in the back. Some of those shots, it looks like they had to open up some flaps on the legs to get the knees to bend. Maybe it's just the way they're just sticking out like that all the time. I don't know.
I do like that ab crunch, though. That's pretty neat.
Mm. I call it a fart crunch. See, by the Sumbo chart, Megatron is basically the same height as Prime.
I always thought he was a little taller. Not a whole lot. Not even a head taller. Well, like maybe like a half head tall.
Well, then I put another picture right afterwards where it is like a slightly taller image of him next to Prime in the cartoon. But it's, I mean, it's slight.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a big, you can't, it's not really huge. But I always thought he was, bigger than Prime. That's what my...
Are there any side shots anywhere of this guy? Because now I want to know what his fucking legs look like from the side. Because I don't see any side shots to see if these flaps stick out.
There are shots of him from behind, which aren't in this link.
Well, there's that one picture in this link where you can see, you know, his legs are bent. You can see his leg from the side. Yeah, but that's, like, I can't tell if, like, would it bother you if to get his knees bent, you have to open flaps behind his calf? Would that bother you? Me? No. Yeah. No.
Dude. That one picture where he got the arm extended with the cannon out, that looks good. Where he's got the hand up like he's saying, come here. I like that. That's how he will look on my shelf. I mean, maybe not with the arm up, but I mean, the bending part, he looks kind of goofy, but.
And his feet. Do you think his feet don't come out far enough from his legs? If you look there?
He's got bigger heel spurs than he does feet or the toes.
I don't know. I think it's a little stumpy there.
I can tell you none of that stuff bothers me. What bothers me about him are those hip skirts. I really don't like how they look.
That bothers me as well.
But Apollyon and the DX9 one, they all have pretty chunky hip skirts.
He has it on the cartoon.
It's not this bad, though, on the other ones.
I agree.
You don't think it's bad on the DX9 one?
No.
The DX9 one maybe, but I haven't really paid that
much. I think the Apollyon one.
Look at that picture Bobby just put up with Prime and Megatron. He's got those big hip skirts. I think they look.
If you look
at, I mean, that's what.
Matt, look at the picture I sent and see how it comes down to not even halfway down his thigh.
And then that's true. Okay.
And then look,
okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Not bad.
If you look at the DX9 Mitron one too, it's closer to that picture you sent, Bobby. It's much smaller.
Interesting. Yeah, I agree. I don't like about the Mitron, guys, I don't like the calves at all.
Yeah, I'm with you. I share that, and I don't think that the knee is far enough back on the calves either.
And I feel like the thighs are too long for the calves.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like that proportion-wise looks weird.
Yeah. Well, see, with the DX9 one, the whole, at his knee, it's in the back of it instead of the front, like in the Make Toys one. Do you know what I'm saying? You know, like when he's bending over, you can see that big gap. Well, on the DX9 one, it looks like it's in the back of it, which is, I mean, that's cool. It hides that. I like that.
The one thing that I think the difference that you're seeing there, Matt, and this is definitely a strength of the MMC one, is the way, like, the calves meet the knee, it's like it's a thinner overall piece from front to back. He's got a thinner calf than the Mitron.
Oh, he does. Yeah, yeah. This one, this one right here, the Make Toys. Yeah, it's more wider, you know, on this knee or from the knee down to the feet, the calf area, and shin is a lot wider than what the DX9 one is, I think.
I don't know.
Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
So I think I'm still probably in on the MMC, but I can say that it's like after seeing reviews and stuff, like I think DX9 is a pretty good competition for this guy, to be completely honest. So you know what else the DX9 has that I really liked over this is the compressible scope, because that fusion cannon is ridiculous looking on this one.
I like the cannon.
No, it's too long.
It could be even bigger, and I'd be happy.
Yeah, I'm with Lenny on that one.
Really? Because it's never looked like that.
It could be masterpiece size.
But that's one of those things, like just like with size with Springer for you. That's one of those things where, like, if the gun looks more intimidating, like, I'm good with that.
Go for it. Yeah.
To each their own, I guess. You know.
Who's yeah. Who's getting both?
John Gibbons.
That's is he? Yep. I'm good. I'm good.
I might get both. I might get both of them too.
I'll send DX9 around to you. Two guys threw almost fell out of my chair. I'll send DX9 around to you guys to take a look at.
Oh man, it's just the reason why I say both is because it's been a long ass time since we've gotten a masterpiece size Megatron.
Didn't Ben's collectible shit on it?
On this?
On the DX9 one.
Any shit on
it? I'm not sure. I didn't. Has he reviewed it? I haven't.
Wait a minute. Pause. What did you say, Matt?
Doesn't he shit on everything?
What?
Ben's collectibles?
No, I don't know. I don't watch him. Sorry.
I think Ben's collectible says everything is usually pretty good.
Oh, okay. Well,
that's why, like, it's a little weird that he shit on this.
On which one?
I don't think he did.
On the DX9.
I don't think he did.
I've heard.
No, he actually. I believe he missed the waist articulation on it.
Well, but it has. But I heard he said this toy is not very good. I heard that that's a quote from that video.
I saw that video. I don't remember him saying that.
I guess I'll have to fucking watch it. I'll watch it.
If y'all look at the pose where he's kind of scrounching and he's got the gun up, his arm cannon way up.
Which number are we talking here?
I don't know. He said scrounching.
There's quite a few where he's scrounching.
Scrounching with his gun off. Tiger.
Seven. The seventh pick.
Seven. Yep.
Look at that. Between his waist and the chest area, it looks like that it's held in between like a really thin plastic. That might be just the something with the drawing or something. Or
which part are we talking here? The waist and the chest?
Yeah, the waist and the chest. You know, with the yellow spot right there.
So not the waist and the chest, more like the hips and the waist.
Yeah.
Okay.
Look at it. It's just like it's hanging.
Well, that ab crunch could possibly be a really big ball joint, maybe. Who knows?
I just wanted to see if anybody else saw that.
Yeah, I can see.
It's kind of weird.
There's a gap. I wouldn't say really big, but there's a gap.
Interesting. Huh.
It's gonna be a tough
one. I like it.
I think this one definitely cleans up on the back. I know, like, I've watched Bobby's reviews. No one displays their toys from the back, but this one cleans up way better on the back than the DX9.
Actually, I'm starting a whole new collection. It's called The Back of the Toys. It's gonna be a whole museum. All it's gonna be is the rear of every toy in a museum.
Oh, mine's gonna be face down, ass up.
But I've watched reviews on both of these, and the transformation on this and the DX9 one are both pretty fucking cool. Like the way that they get there in from both toys. So I think
that's all that matters.
You buy either one, you win. You're gonna have a fun transformation.
Yeah, as long as you have fun with it, that's all that matters.
Agreed.
If I can sell my Apollyon for a good price, I think I'm in on the DX9 one, and then I'll make a decision on MMC or make toys later. So
didn't you put that up?
I did. That's why I said if it sells.
All right. Good job.
Everyone go to the cafe.
Buy my shit.
Help.
There's a Despotron. What was it? $110?
I think so, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Good deal.
That is a good price. All right. I have no regrets that I got also... my Polyon like 8 months ago.
Yeah, me either. We have four alternate faces for Despotron as well from Make Toys. So everyone who's been photoshopping the DX9 ones head on, you've got options.
I like that. I like the laughing one or the, you know.
Yeah, I like the really big open mouth, like evil smile one, and I like the crooked mouth one as well.
I can never bring myself to use super emotive faces.
Yeah, me neither.
Like even on SH Figure Arts or Play Art stuff, like if I get like all these alternate heads that have like these like screaming faces and stuff, like I just can't bring myself to do it.
The only
it's good for photos though.
Like, yeah, sure. Absolutely.
The only alternate head that I've ever been like super in love with was the original MP Starscream, and I loved having the one with the smirk. That's all I needed.
The smirk, you know?
Yeah, that was cool.
Dude, look at that next picture with Springer. He's fucking huge.
What are we talking about?
Nobody. Alrighty. If you go to the next page, the next after the faces, look how that Springer is
He's a big, beefy. Big
boy. Yeah, it's a big toy.
Yeah, that's why I don't.
Yeesh.
I don't know. That was cool for that, but...
Yeah, it's cool for that guy. The options of the faces is cool, but you know, yeah. It's not for everybody.
All right.
Okay. Wait, we've got one more. Who the fuck is Open Play? So, is this
what the hell is that?
This is another Springer. So there you go. There is another one.
This is the Springer I've been waiting for.
Yeah, this is the one.
Is that the spongy?
What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this?
He cleans up spills and messes. And it's Springer.
Yeah. Maybe it's just the head. It's just the head they're showing.
No, I think Bold Forms have changed their name to Open Play, and you're going to get Bold Forms Springer.
I mean, agree.
It looks good.
Yeah, if it is Bold Forms, I think Open Play is a perfect name for the company because it has all the panels open when you're messing with them. You know,
he's got the ox.
He's got fur. Shoulders.
He's got the ox shoulders.
Where are you seeing photos?
Wait a minute. If you click the link that's in the description on that page,
technology. Yeah, Bobby knows how to use it.
It looks like I want to get my golf clothes out and start putting.
Thank you.
It looks like he's got some green on him.
That's where you go with that one.
Are you talking about the drawing?
Yeah.
That's a drawing of the Fans Toys one, the Unique Toys one, and the Toy World one.
Oh, okay. Well, that's weird. Because it says...
I think Open Play is just someone that has a Weibo account, and everyone's getting a little confused here.
I gotcha.
Oh, are we getting a Black Sentinel Prime? What is that? I love those colors.
I don't even know what Matt's looking at this point.
I don't either.
If you click on the pictures, you get the gun... Whatever. Anyways. Whoever made this Sentinel Prime.
Whatever.
Kudos.
I see a picture looking like the Jesus statue in Rio. As I click through the pictures. I don't know. It's pretty weird.
Yeah, I've been to that thing. Big Jesus.
Big Jesus. Big baby Jesus.
Gave him a high five.
8 pound 10 ounce baby Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Big baby Jesus. All right,
that's the end of third party news. So we're up to Matthew Baldwin, part of the show. Shout out and honorable mentions to Titans Returns possible new figures.
Yes.
Hey guys,
if they make some of these figures, I'll be interested. As long as you're not, I guess, I don't know, they'll probably be headmasters, but I want a the Monster Bots. I'm okay with that.
I want Monster Bots too, but I don't want them in the scale. So
yeah, I'll still get them. It's fine.
Who's I've been looking for a Shuffler for a long time.
Right back in the 90s.
What is he, a fucking deck of cards? No, it's one of the machines. Like you play with a deck of cards and you dump it in the top. It has like a little wind up gimmick and it shuffles them up and then spits them out to different players.
Lazy.
He was a gambler on Cybertron. Are you kidding? I can't even tell. Yes, I'm kidding. Fuck. Who the fuck is Shuffler? What a Shuffler. Personality. Gets too much.
So, anyway, they got little Titan Masters.
I'm actually okay with Shuffler. He's one of those weird Japanese headmasters. Like, it was just the headmaster. It's,
Head on.
He turned into an elephant instead of a little human.
Shuffle personality raises the stakes.
He should
shuffle. Shuffler. Getaway is going to probably be Chrome Dome. Quake is going to be. Quake was the tank, right? Shit, that might be in his mold.
Isn't that Fans Toys?
Yeah, I'm looking at some third party fucking names here.
Brock. This ain't no fuck that shit. They had this shit before fucking Fans Toys. Croc. What was he? I don't know. Topspin, Perceptor, and Sergeant Cup. So, there might be some new molds out of that one. Perceptor might be. He could probably be Hardhead, maybe.
I reckon he'll be Blaster for sure.
What I don't understand is why does everybody have.
No, they're all Deluxes.
This ID number, with the exception of Sergeant Cup, whose reason for not having one is name length. Just doesn't add them feel to like double space.
That's space, man. You can't add a fucking number after space.
And they use.
I mean, I don't know. Whatever.
Well, I mean, I would like to see monster bots, but I still probably wouldn't pick them up. I'm closing the doors on the chug life.
MMC's chug? Still got your back on chug life, Bobby. Don't turn your back on MMC.
Well, except for IDW.
Me.
Except for IDW.
Yeah. If you like this shit, like Matt Baldwin, you win. So, well done, Matt.
Yeah, I always win.
Uh-huh. What else do we got? We got a statue. Prime uh-oh. 1 Studio Generation 1 Megatron statue promotional images.
Fucking beautiful.
Yeah. It's Megatron.
Damn. That's what he look, that's what he should look like in the movie.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Yeesh.
Wait, where's the... okay, here we go.
That's like $2,500 probably.
Yeah. That's... Oh,
$5,000 or $20,000.
This is fine.
Oh, Jesus.
They, shut up. They, we got a message on Shatteredcast this week of somebody telling us about the statues, like the Soundwave statue that we were talking about. Did anybody see that?
I did not.
I did not, no.
All right, it's from Lotus Stark. Shout out to that dude.
Hey, yeah, Lotus.
He's hit us up a few times with kind of useful information. But,
only kind of useful, though. Only kind.
Not totally useful. Just kind. He said,
it's only kind of useful because Bobby didn't think of it first.
No.
Ah, that's all true.
Just the latest episode, Imaginarium Art is located in Singapore. They don't have a license to sell to the U.S. for most products such as Marvel. We don't know if the Transformers line is for the U.S. market yet. So basically, if you want one of their products, you would have to make friends with people in Singapore and they ship to you. Normally, they take a deposit of 200 Singapore dollars. These large format statues are normally retail around 1,200 Singapore dollars, which is about 900, but shipping is killer. The size of the box along with the weight cost me around 350 to 450 Singapore dollars. The good part is most sellers ship DHL, so you get it in about 4 days. If you guys ever want to know anything about the statue world, let me know, et cetera. Kind of agree with Bobby. For me, it's exciting to unbox and put the statue together, et cetera, et cetera. So anyway, yeah, we're guessing that it's in the to get it to your door, that Soundwave is going to be around 1,200 bucks.
Dude, if you can get this for me for free Singapore dollars, I'd be happy.
Free Singapore dollars, yeah.
Because 1,200 Singapore dollars does not sound good on my wallet, but free Singapore dollars does. So holler at me if you want to get me a statue.
Yeah. I mean, okay. All right. What Megatron is this supposed to be? I'm confused.
It's just their Megatron.
It's Prime 1 Megatron. That's what it is.
And it's just a statue.
And I feel like his cannon's a little bit stumpy.
I'm okay with the cannon.
Yeah.
No, Robert, this does transform, man.
Yeah, you drop it on the floor, it'll transform all right.
Mm-hmm. Transforming him.
Don't send it to me.
Yeah, transforms into transforming him.
Transforms into.
I don't know. I mean, why? Okay, I don't understand who would spend that much money on a statue that doesn't actually represent any other representations of the character. They just came up.
True Transformer really fan. That's what.
Do you own a Leonidas?
I guess Megatron is their focus character. Maybe like.
Yeah. Anybody wants to get Megatron? That's who'll get it. That has the money.
It's kind of like when you buy a Leonidas that you're never going to transform and you have no real draw to the character or anything like that, but you're like, hey, he kind of looks cool. I'm going to put him on the shelf. Mm-hmm. Which is why I have a Leonidas.
I transform my Leonidas like 30 times. That's why he broke 5 times.
Mm-hmm.
That's true. That's why he broke so much, but he's fun to transform.
Shout out to the Prime 1 photographer for using that same Sparks app on every single photo as well.
Ugh,
that's not
dirty.
Part of the statue? Rip off.
God bless
him. He's riding dirty.
All right. do we have anything left?
Just shout out to just everybody.
Hasbro. All right. Shout out to a diecast Soundwave add-on.
Hmm?
So Hasbro Asia are re-releasing Soundwave. So everyone who Just paid $400 for one. Sock it.
Sock. No she rat bat. Casper one anyway.
Yeah. Yellow eyes.
Ugh. Yeah, the yellow eyes shit is not for me.
He has yellow eyes in this one, too.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm. Well, does this one transform into the lamppost? There's not a true sine wave if you don't transform to that lamppost. Or lamppost.
He comes with a mini diecast version of himself. Is that what they're saying?
Yep.
Oh, well, shit.
They haven't made it yet, though. They don't know what it looks like, so it's just
it's not even going to look like a sound wave.
They're just going to wing it.
Just a box.
I bet it looks
like it's blaster. It's going to be blaster.
They should have thrown rat bat in it.
Mm-hmm. That's what a lot of people are saying. It's like, no rat bat still.
Yeah, that's pretty fucked.
Hey, kudos if you ain't found sound wave yet, but how much is he going to be? What, $200, I think? I don't know. Shit.
Yeah, probably.
All right. Oh. We got a couple questions for this week. Actually, one thing I wanted to talk about with the Megatron. So there's like rumors coming out that Takara is making one, right? And these rumors are starting to circulate. My question is this to you guys. Is with the extreme kind of cartoon accuracy that Takara has been going recently. I got this from Feral Rahi. I watched a vlog recently. And with the extreme like cartoon accuracy directions they've been going recently, do you think that he will be gray and not silver?
Oh.
I can kind of see that happening.
Me too.
Yeah. Wouldn't surprise me. And it wouldn't even surprise me if there was some other later release that he is silver.
Oh, exclusive?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but there's no way they're going to make them. They're not going to make them a gun.
Well, let's just say they did. You know, let's just say they did for the sake of argument. Do you? What color do you think they'll go with?
I can see being gray first.
Yeah, I think they'll go gray.
Black and yellow.
Do you have an opinion, Lenny?
Yeah, look, if it happens, then maybe, yeah, they could do a gray one, but I don't know about the gun thing.
I think they put an orange tip.
Yeah.
You know, I'm gonna go back on my statement. I think they're still gonna do them silver based on like the paint jobs they've been giving the other MPs and stuff like that. Yeah, I think he's still going to be silver because I think their justification is going to be that you can't make metallic silver in a cartoon, really. You know? And they'll be like, well, he's always supposed to be that
one. I like your idea. I like your first idea. I think they could do the gray first and then do either a second run or an exclusive, like an Asian exclusive, to be silver.
What paint job do you think? What paint job are you basing that opinion on?
What are you talking about?
Like you said, given their other paint jobs.
Think like any of the cars that have gotten, you know, very special paint jobs.
Ironhide.
Like take like Trax. Like Trax has that metallic-y finish to him, and he was, you know, super blue. You know.
That's true. Cartoon. That's true. So, that's fair.
Yeah. Blue Streak's got kind of a metallic-y
finish. Yeah, but Blue Streak is back in the good old days.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think ultimately though, I think they've, with the market that Takara is trying to appeal to, it's going to make him seem more premium if he has a metallic paint job. And
but it could be like a gray metallic.
It could be, I guess.
Well, if it's a premium, I could see them saving it for an exclusive then.
Yeah, I can see that too. All right. Well, I mean,
either way, it's a win. I mean, whatever, you know.
I mean, you're not getting really too inaccurate because he's gonna mass shift, you know. I mean,
it's not
gonna be. Why not? It's not. Why not? It's not gonna be a good.
Brennan has a question. So here's a question, guys. Do you think one day the Masterpiece line will reboot again? By this, I mean another scale change and maybe go smaller again. Would you guys collect it or not? Looking forward to your responses.
That's a good dude.
Yeah. I can see them rebooting, but I don't think necessarily it'll be smaller.
Yeah.
But I don't see any evidence of a reboot though.
Yeah, I don't.
Wouldn't it be a kick in the teeth if they rebooted it back to MP01 scale? We're going this way again. You got to go left and we're going right.
Surprise. Do you think that there was any like indication though that they were going to reboot the scale the first time? I mean, it just kind of happens that Rodimus can fit between the two scales, like Hot Rod for MP01 and Rodimus for MP10, but like I don't think anybody saw it coming just because it worked that way.
Yeah, I know. No, I don't. Yeah, that's true. That's fair. During that time, they were just doing like so. It was so scarce. You know, now they're cranking them out.
Yeah, that's true. The other thing for me personally though is like if they were to reboot Masterpiece, which could happen. It could happen. They could be like, all right, well, we can't afford to make them bigger. We're gonna start making them smaller. But for me, the problem is like if you go smaller than MP10, like you're starting to go back to like classic size for me, and you know, like the cars would be old school deluxe classics, and like they're just not worth that premium to me.
Yeah, but also I think that the whole thing with them rebooting would be to get another Optimus.
Well, of course, always where they start the reboot. Yeah. You know.
And I can see them rebooting. Well, go ahead, Robert. I think you're ready to say what I'm going to say. Go ahead.
I think they're going to just, quote unquote, reboot. It'll just be the next line, like Energon. Yeah, you know, just go to the next series. You know,
no, I think they're
looking forward to it.
I can see them redoing Optimus to match more so what they're doing now, where it's more clean panels and not the line work that MP10 has or Sideswipe. Like, I can see them doing that. Where now Optimus looks like Shockwave.
Do you think Jazz is going to be more on line with Prowl and, you know, and Sideswipe or Ironhide?
Ironhide.
That's going to suck.
What was the last Masterpiece? Who was the last Masterpiece?
Ratchet? You. Was it Ratchet?
Okay. Like I said. What's the next one?
The next one is Inferno.
Oh, yeah. Okay. The reason why I don't see I don't see a reboot because I mean there's so many.
Ruby. Go ahead, Matt.
There's so many, you know, characters they have not even touched. I mean, I understand why they would, but I just
money.
I don't. Yeah, I mean, I just don't want them to because there's just so much you could do. But it's just weird, like you know, there's. We don't need another Prime. I'm sorry. I like what we have.
We can move on.
I mean, we can move on, and you can later on do the line. I mean, do another Prime. But there's so many characters you can do that I just don't think they're spitting them out. You know, a lot quicker.
Look at how many we've gotten.
Better than used to. But
we got new molds too. Ratchet. Tracks.
Can I tell you something?
Thrust.
Was Tracks this year?
Before you go on, Bobby. Let me just point out that Matt is not as big of a Transformers fan as he lets on. As coming shortly, we have some Beast Wars ones that just seem to be completely written off. MP only is only vehicles to Matt. That's all I'm saying.
I love it. I'm excited for the Beast Wars, and I understand why they're doing it. But I just there's other characters in G1 that they need to touch on before. I understand why they're going because of the anniversary. And I think they're only going to do a couple, which is fine. That's cool. But they need to get back into G1 mode. And
if they sell, they're doing all of them. Go ahead,
just
Robert.
As Bobby has pointed out, that Beast Wars made it okay to just change everything.
Yeah. And
I think when they Ruby the Masterpiece line again, Beast Wars is set the precedence. They're going to Ruby it into the next line after Beast Wars.
Are you going to call me a drink, T-Pain?
I don't know. I think the thing is I think if Cheetor, see, Cheetor is the monkey wrench, you might say, and the whole thing, because Cheetor is saying that they're going beyond Primal. Because I could see them doing just all the primes, like from all the different things, like MP versions of all the primes. But when they release Cheetor, that suggests that they're going to do more of the Beast Wars characters. So I think
they're just doing a couple, though.
We don't know that.
You don't know.
If they make a lot of money, why would they only?
They're doing only a couple for the 20th anniversary.
Matt, if Cheetor and Primal sell out, you're getting more.
It's kind of like Bay said, he was only doing one movie, and then he did two, and then he did three, and he's not coming back again, but guess what? Keeps making that money, guess who's going to keep coming back?
If so how many have they released this year, Bobby? They have, was Trax, I thought Trax was last year.
I was just saying, with from a year from today.
Okay.
But this year, okay, let's say Trax was last year, so we got Ironhide, we got Ratchet, we got Ramjet, we got and then we got all the repaints.
Shockwave. We got Shockwave.
We got Laser Wave or whatever. Yeah. So then, and then we're supposed to get Inferno. We're supposed to get Rust. We might get Dirge.
Okay.
I mean, you know, they're cranking them
out. I mean, no, they're cranking them out better than they did YouTube. Yeah. I mean, yeah. Definitely. I wish they'd do it. Well, I say that wrong. I don't wish they would do faster because I want them to be good. I don't want them to spit out a bunch of shit. So I'm kind of, I like the pace they're going at, I guess.
God, when I was dusting my shelves, I picked up Trax and his knees are so fucking wobbly. That's how it sounded when I picked him up.
Let me go pick up a third shit.
I'll tell you what, the MP stuff, like the cone heads, they don't excite me. I mean, Trax, even though I have him, I wish I didn't. You know, like it used to be when an MP came out, it was a must have. And for me, at least, it's not like that anymore.
It depends. Like I'm really excited about their Inferno. Like, their Inferno looks... But, I was also really excited about their Shockwave, and their Shockwave was kind of a bummer.
Man, fuck TFC.
I agree.
They're just putting out shit just to put out shit, man.
I agree.
God damn.
So much money. So much money. Anyways.
So then we got a question.
Thank you for the question. That was a good question.
Yes, thank you. We got a question from MP Collector.
Yay!
Shocker!
Thank God.
It'll be a dick number. He's the only reason why you're here.
I have titled this week's question "The Derp of Perceptor."
Derp.
I've lost track of how many times I have heard a fellow collector express a criticism of fans' toy of Tesla, only to have the response sound something along the lines of, yeah, but you can only do so much with Perceptor. He's just so derpy. For some reason, I got to thinking about poor Perceptor this week, and I couldn't come up with a good reason for him to have gotten such a bad rap from us fans over the years. This line of thought led me to two questions for the SCU crew. First, what do you guys think it is about Perceptor that have caused him to be pigeonholed as such a derpy character? Second, are there any other Transformers that come to mind that fall within the same derpy category Perceptor does? I cannot come up with any, but I would love to hear if you guys can. I think that the reason why is just because, like, what he transforms into is just like his legs bend and you sit him down. You know, and like
giant microscope box.
Right. So I think that's why like it's going to be boring. It's never going to be exciting. But like, I don't have like, it's nice that they're going to put out a new Perceptor face, and I guess it's better. But like, I don't really need a new Perceptor face. Like, my Perceptor is fine. I don't have any complaints with my Perceptor.
I don't either.
Looks great on the show.
But I think that the reason why he gets that is because of his boring transformation, like just historically, and then that he's kind of like a boring character.
In the
cartoon.
Yeah. IDW made him pretty cool, but yeah.
Agreed.
The cartoon, not so much.
Agreed. And I think that Cosmos kind of gets thrown in there too, in derpiness.
Easy. I would say him and Seaspray. Seaspray is very, I mean, like,
yeah.
There's not so much you can do with Seaspray either. Like, when it comes down to it, it's like the feet have to be the front of the boat. The propellers on the back have to go behind his head, which leaves you like, okay, he's got a white body, and the rest of it's going to have to be the pontoons of the hover boat make his arms. You know, like, he's not going to be all that interesting either.
I would throw maybe Grimlock and Shockwave into that. I don't know if they're derpy, but... there's so much you can do with Grimlock and Shockwave.
Yeah, but Grimlock's still a fun and interesting transformation.
No, he is.
And character. I think that has a lot to do with it. Yeah. I think that it's the character.
Throw them out then. Shit.
But I think Eject and Rewind are kind of like boring characters.
If I'm honest, I think Blaster is too, but there's more. That he is a big rectangle, there's more you can do with actually making the transformation interesting. You know?
Racist.
What about Rover, that idiot tape that came with Blaster?
He's a fucking dick.
He's a fucking dick.
I'll tell you which one always.
Would you say that about Soundwave too, though? Mm-hmm. If you put Blaster in there?
I would, but like I said, it's the fact that he is an actual like cube / rectangle that you know. I'm trying to figure out the best way to
describe
it.
I understand like, what you're saying.
Yeah, like it's
just a boombox. You know?
Because you can actually do things to hide things and shift panels and all that to make him rectangular, I think it lends itself to a more interesting transformation than the guy whose torso is the main part of the microscope and the legs are the base and the arms just kind of tuck away somewhere. You know, like, right. I don't know. Like, to an extent, they're a boring character, but there's more you can do with them given the nature of their alt mode.
You know what's funny is, like, retrospectively, like KFC put that blaster out, and nobody's fucked with it.
Yeah, nobody's done anything. Nobody's
played with it.
Yeah.
You know, everybody's kind of been like, yep, that'll do. I'll leave it, you know, like.
Well, give you that one, KFC. All right.
Yeah. Well, see, and I think the problem is, like, and with that is, like, just like the other toys, like, what could you do to that to a new blaster that would be so superior to it that it's worth just getting rid of it, you know?
I have an answer. With a whole new set of really good tapes.
But that's not Blaster.
Are you talking about KFC tapes?
Not KFC tapes. But, I mean, if they came out with, if a third-party company came out with another version didn't have Blaster, but just came out with, did their own version of the tapes, but they weren't shit, you know?
But I don't know. I think people would just pick up the tapes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You have to buy them all.
Because they have a blaster. $100. What would you. I don't think that has to do anything with Blaster.
Maybe the end game for MMC is to put out all the tapes in real life scale and then make a blaster and a sound wave to go with it.
He's going
to
be so huge. Mm. Shit. What about. Maybe not Omega, maybe?
I think Sharktacons have a pretty derpy transformation. It's just like open the mouth, head comes out.
Yeah, but I think it's more.
Feet become arms, and then you just fold out its tail to become its legs. Like, there's not really any other way you can do it that works.
Yeah, but I think it's more to it that causes the derpiness, though. I think, like, there's a character element that always, like, that has to, like, match it. Because, like, you know, like we said, like, Grimlock kind of has to do it sort of the same way, and Shockwave kind of has to do it similarly, and you know, but they're cool characters, so everybody gives them a pass. Whereas Perceptor, it's like, oh man, like your transformation matches your personality, kind of thing.
Yeah, nerd.
Well, a thing that this is off the subject. I'm sorry, but the Omega always pissed me off is he was such a strong bot, but he got his ass whooped every fucking cartoon. And I never understood that. Like, he was like one of the top, you know, at the beginning of season one, maybe season two, that, you know, he was one of the most powerful Autobots. And then he got his ass handed to him every fucking time. And I was like, what is wrong with Omega Supreme?
You know what would be a good idea? The
Constructicons broke his heart.
I like that. I like that backstory. You know what the you know what a good idea would be for a third party company, like this X Factory company? Would be to make a non-transforming, highly posable giant bot that they used as a hologram to scare off Devastator or whatever at the Heavy Metal War.
Yeah.
I think Hound did it.
That'd be cool.
Oh yeah, I got one. Metroplex. Metroplex, there's... like, oh, city mode. I mean, especially the Generations one with his fucking.
Well, then you
hands.
Had to say that to every like you know Trypticon and Scorponok.
No, I don't think so. I think Trypticon looks great in base mode.
So does
you know, Scorponok. Not really. He kind of looks like he's just sitting with his legs spread. You know.
Well, you know, maybe he had cheerleading tryouts or something.
And especially the Generation Toys one. I mean, not Generation Toys. The Generations one. His fucking hands just... He's holding his own. He's flipping his hands down.
What
you
else
know,
do you
want
to do? He's a fucking city boss.
I mean, okay, look at Utopia. Utopia looks much better.
Yeah, because Utopia costs fucking $400. I'd hope it fucking look, you know, try to...
$200.
But he,
you know,
Utopia still looks like he's sitting on his leg or doing the splits.
He looks awesome.
I mean, he does. I'm not saying he doesn't, but he does the same thing what Metroplex does.
Yeah, he squares off better though. He looks less like.
Are we looking at the same Utopia or not? I don't think
he doesn't
we are
look
looking.
Like he's doing Matthew Baldwin floor time as much as Generations.
Yeah, that's true. Nobody can do the Matthew Baldwin floor time, but I'm just saying.
I have more time getting my front flaps on my Metroplex to stay connected. I picked him up to vacuum the other day. And like he just like it was like lifting up a dead child, like it was like it just like every joint failed.
Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
Have you ever tried adding any more paint to that guy, or you just stopped?
I think I just stopped, man. I don't have to like it's like it's on my to-do list, but it's like I just can't be bothered at the same time. It's like it doesn't matter how much paint I add to it, it's not gonna look as good as Utopia. And he always has to stand like a fucking. Like the little statue at the movie theater used to hold the mints.
I think I've learned some things about Bobby that make me uncomfortable. He knows what a dead child feels like, stuff like that. I don't know. Since we've
its legs fall off.
Yeah, I think Bobby's job is a serial killer. That's what it is.
Yes, yeah, he does have a big basement with many layers.
Oh, what about the? Oh, sorry.
Flexible schedule. I have a flexible schedule. It's just $5,000 ahead, and
all right. Then
what about the Insecticons?
Insecticons, they got heaps of personality though.
Yeah.
So they're excluded as
well. I mean, they got personality, but you know their transformation is.
Yeah, but that's the thing. That's what I keep saying. G1 is that like. That's what I'm saying, though, is that it's not just one or the other. It's the thing with Perceptor. The reason what makes Perceptor unique is that. His transformation and his personality are both lame.
I guess I guess I read questions different than what y'all do because y'all are just totally go off on something and I'm reading it as something else. But
yeah, but he's saying like why? No, I was saying that's what I think it is. Like that's why he is so derpy. It's because he's boring and his transformation is boring.
Yeah.
Well, okay. I think. You know that the fans. I think he's arguably Fans Toys' weakest offering. You know, so is this maybe Fans Toys' fault? You know that he's kind of blah on the shelf. Like
it'd be everybody's fault. There's nobody. There's nothing you really could do to make it, unless you turn him into a tank or something.
Well, you don't know. I mean, because no one else has really tried their hand at it, and could have been. Well, I think it's as see the thing that he's almost frustrating for me because. He could transform pretty simply, but he doesn't. You know, it's like a little annoying things, even though it's ultimately a pretty simple transformation, which kind of annoys me about him because he's not fun to transform for me, at least. Because I'm like, there's no payoff, and parts of it are just annoying.
No chance of breaking. I don't like this.
Maybe you're right. Maybe you are right.
Wait, was that Bobby or Robert?
Yeah, shit. I'm in that category these days. Ever since Robert sent me that DX9, he must have like passed it like AIDS to me.
Curse.
That was like the what's it? The Diary of a Wimpy Kid with the cheese touch. You know what I'm talking about?
Fuck no. Because I'm
not
five.
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Just some rotten cheese in a playground, and some kid touched it, and it was like having cooties, and you pass it on.
But
on the
cheese to be touch. Fair and honest, you know, I'm not five thing, but you do play with toys, so.
No, I do.
No, you do.
I do.
You do.
No, I don't.
You do.
No, I don't.
What do you got in your basement, Bobby B?
Collectibles.
Hey, what do you have? What do you have in your drawer by your sink, Matt?
A gun. A dildo.
Yeah, a gun.
Forks and knives.
Gun, dildo.
Does that mean you play with them?
Kudos.
Yes. No, Matt goes to business with them. Yeah, Matt goes to work.
How's the weigh-in?
Is that a fat joke? I'm still good. I lost another 3 pounds, so I'm up to 35.
Nice.
So, good job.
Yeah.
Good job.
And my stomach is shrinking, and I feel better. I've been working out. I've been riding the bike now. I'm up to like 25 minutes now, so I've been doing about 5 miles a day on the bike. So, and I'm lifting weights too a little bit. I started lifting.
What,
a little, so.
Dude? You are gonna be so slow.
Oh, bench press, Robert.
Yeah, we are so gonna rape you.
What?
No, not if he's getting all powerful.
I might rape you, man.
Oh, he's got TFCon money. He doesn't have Skullfest money. He's got TFCon money.
Oh, have you seen the things that Matt bought at TFCon though? I mean, like, really? I mean,
yeah.
He needs that money for TFCon.
Yeah, he's got Dreadwing money.
I need it. Anyway, that's a good question, MP Collector. Thank you very much. And please tell me your name because I forgot it.
Gary.
Okay.
Gary. It's Gary. Steve.
You don't have Facebook, so I can't look you up.
MP Collector's a man of mystery, man. He's just MP Collector.
He is. He'll get on the ROC though. He likes him some ROC. But who doesn't?
Who doesn't?
You know. So that's a good question. Thank you very much.
ROC is tight like J. Rue shorts.
Tight rope.
That's what I'm saying.
He's got like slut rips in his legs.
No, I'm saying, like, next time somebody says something like nasty to me on YouTube, I'm just gonna be like, hey man, I will roll up on you like J. Rue shorts.
Oh, you're rolling fucking deep like that.
Shit. I love that dude.
You said when he came up, he's like, it's not the part that he had shorts on, but he had them tight rolled. Like they were tight. tight.
It was like rolled up down the bottom. I was just like, man, they just threw me for a loop. I think he's more like a fashionable dude. I don't pretend to understand fashion, so I'll just take his word for it that it's something cool, too cool for me to understand.
Some kind of hipster shit, I'd say.
True that, man.
And he's a little fella, man, so he can pull that shit off. If I were to do that shit, you guys laugh me out of the room.
Shout out to Jay Bruce. Fuck you, Jay Bruce.
Yeah. And we're all out of questions, so everybody get to it and send us some more questions for next week.
Yeah, short show this week.
Yeah. Yeah, or discussions. You know, if you want to send us a discussion. Are we going to have a discussion about anything? Trademark? Something?
Oh, the trademark thing I was just going to mention, like, it was brought up on, I don't know if it was brought up on my channel or Shattercast channel. It's been something that I've been meaning to mention, just about people that say the shit like, well, third party is IP theft and like all that shit. And like, yeah, but like, you weren't supposed to be able to have a lock on that shit for so long anyway. It's only the Mickey Mouse. I mean, Justin probably knows this shit inside out better than I do, but like,
the IP stuff can happen definitely.
but wasn't it?
Copyright has a definite time period where it ends, and but Disney is responsible for it being extended. What is it? 70 years now?
I don't know. But it was like real short. But Mickey Mouse has like kept pushing it back and back and back.
Yeah, I think it's a life plus 70, as I recall.
Could you imagine they lost
when I was in law school? Mickey Mouse. They will. Yeah.
Because like I think it's supposed to come up. I think Mickey Mouse is supposed to come up again either this year or next year.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay. and then they're going to have to do some other legal
shit. Yeah, but they're making that Star Wars and Marvel money now. They can just fucking extend that indefinitely.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, that's true, but Mickey Mouse is iconic. I mean, that's
it's not a money thing though. It's like a legal thing. I mean, yeah, obviously money can influence legalities. I'm not saying they
I mean, you'd have to change Disney World and Disneyland, you'd have to change all that shit up. And
speaking of Star Wars, man,
you don't have to change any of that stuff because that's probably all trademarked and stuff. So,
right.
Oh,
I mean,
okay,
you can even come down to. I'm pretty sure you can get the entire look of Mickey Mouse can be trademarked, and as a result, I don't think that they really have to worry about someone making their own Mickey Mouse. But the thing about trademarks is like they're a confusing subject because like if you've ever gone...
Pun intended.
I'm not sure what the pun was there, Robert, but...
because of the purpose of a trade...
Did I say a dick or a fart joke? I'm not really sure what the... Confusion. Anyway.
The purpose Shut of a trademark is to prevent against consumer confusion. That was a lawyer joke, I guess.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, like, the confusing part about it is, like, the amount that something has to vary based on the original, its original incarnation is, it's different. You know, like, it's like there only has to be, and I don't know the exact number, I think it's like something like 15 or 20% different than the trademark to not be violating it. So it's like,
right, but go ahead.
If you made like a parody Mickey with like three ears and three eyes or something, like probably not going to be a problem, you know. And like, well, where Transformers is concerned, I mean, first off, there's probably not trademarks on every single character, and you know, when you get a Springer, like, you, I'm certain, and it's the reason that we don't have, you know, names like Jazz. It has to be like Autobot Jazz and stuff like that now, is because Hasbro hasn't kept up their funding of their IPs, you know. And so,
right,
like,
but there's
really
supposed to be a shit where it becomes public domain.
Yeah, well, public domain, I think, I don't know how that would work with respect to the character like this, to be honest.
Trademark, yeah. Goes, the heart of a trademark goes to the company and the manufacturer of a product. So if there's no confusion, even if it looks the same, if there's no consumer confusion, you could argue that it does not infringe on a trademark.
Right. And
you're talking about copyright stuff.
Yeah.
With public domain, that's all copyright.
Yeah, and I think that the issue with the copyright would be the ability for somebody out there to play, you know, like stream a episode of G1 on YouTube or something like that. Like, that's where the copyright would come into play. But like, the actual, you know, the characters and stuff are not protected by that type of thing. Those would have to be all trademarked, and I would be willing to bet outside of names, like the actual likenesses are not trademarked, and nobody's buying, I don't know, I'm trying to think of a good one, like the MMC or the Make Toys Megatron that we were talking about. Nobody is buying it and confusing it for the Transformers brand that currently exists, you know. So there's no issue there, and they're not calling it Megatron, you know. It doesn't look like any Megatron currently, so
no, it doesn't have chicken legs, so it's definitely not official. So
yeah, so
yes, it's a copy. The copyright term, the Copyright Term Extension Act, CTEA.
Oh, look at you, Google man.
1998 extended copyright terms in the United States. Since the Copyright Act of 1976, copyright would last for the life of the author plus 50 years or 75 years for a work of corporate authorship. The 1976 Act also increased the extension term for works copyrighted before 1978 that had not already entered the public domain from 28 years to 47 years. Oof.
Keep talking.
This law, also known as the Sonny Bono Copyright Term Act, or
this is like bringing back fucking hell memories from law school, trying to like study for finals, like trying to fucking remember all this shit and memorize it and knowing to apply it. It was horrible.
It's also known as the Mickey Mouse Protection Act. Effectively froze the advancement date of the public domain in the United States for works covered by the older fixed term copyright rules.
Keep talking.
You end up reading this shit three times over, backwards, trying to understand what the fuck you're reading.
Yeah.
You know. I believe, as I recall, the characters are copywritten, you know, so, you know, and you know, if they just, an argument, like if they, you know, if somebody copied an MP Soundwave and called it something else, they could argue that you're copying their copy, you know, you're infringing on their copyright.
Right, but
can you
copy
something?
Is the copyright, you know, the way that shit has been manipulated by corporate interest, is that moral to begin with?
I agree with you. I don't think it is.
If Justin works for Walmart and he creates a character that becomes a Walmart brand, like, should Walmart as an entity, like as a corporation,
By the way, I've designed this character in my head. He looks just like Megatron, and he destroys the competition. That's all I'm saying.
With a smiley face.
What's your question? Would you say that his personality could be summed up in Peace of Tyranny?
Yes.
Wait, what's your question? No. Finish your question.
Mine's not a question. Peace through rollback. That's all I'm saying.
You were saying if Justin...
Rollback. Yeah. And then
that was a good one, Justin.
Is it morally, like, you know, ethically, how do you feel about a corporation, a non-living entity, owning a property?
Well, here's the deal. There's the thing called work for hire, you know? If I, you know, like, if you had your illustrations and you wanted to really expand it for your charitable works, so you bring on some other illustrators to come up with some more illustrations. But then they started selling them on the side. And they're saying, fuck you, I drew these. Would that bother you? But you hired them for your company for the purpose that you decided.
I think the best way that Bobby, that I can compare it to, that Bobby's trying to explain, is through Marvel or DC or whatever, is like, does Jack Kirby own Captain America? Or does Marvel own Captain America? Or does what was the other guy, the guy that wrote?
Fun Pub.
Yeah, does Fun Pub own Captain America? I mean, and there's that whole thing, like, Rob Liefeld sued Marvel for Deadpool royalties and all of that shit.
So, what you call it? I mean, I think the most famous one is Siegel and Shuster.
For Superman?
For Superman.
Yeah.
Because they were never credited as creating Superman, you know, and it's always been a DC thing. It's actually one of the reasons why New 52 happened, and it's one of the reasons why Man of Steel happened. Was because of that lawsuit.
But then you've got Transformers, and they've taken characters from all these other toy lines previous to even Hasbro existing, or as far as I know, like Diaclone and all of that. So, like, yeah, who owns it?
Look, I'll tell you what, just at the heart of it morally,
please tell me.
I do not like the whole, you know, existence of corporations. I don't like it at all. They are considered legal people.
That's what I'm saying.
You know, and the purpose of a corporation is to make money. And I mean, it's just
money.
I think ultimately it's an evil purpose. Their sole purpose is to make money for its investors. So they will do everything they can to make more and more and more and more and more money. It's very parasitic for the rest of society. You know, they're not bound by the other, you know, they're not raised as people and, you know, given morals and ethics, you know, it's just board of directors and whatnot. But the whole purpose is just to make money, increase profits over and over again.
Because it wasn't
initially revolution.
It wasn't initially set up where, you know, a business could own a character.
Right.
You know, so it just goes into that whole third party being stealing. And it's like, well, yeah, but at the same time, you can make the argument that they're just taking back what should be public domain anyway, or what should be for the people anyway. Now, of course, there's the making money off of it and all that. And I get all that. I'm just saying that, you know, Hasbro isn't a tangible thing. So why should it be able to own something?
Yeah, I mean that's
their idea.
That's a very foundational issue with regard to corporations.
But it's not Hasbro's idea. It's not Hasbro's idea, Matt.
Didn't they buy it off of whoever idea it was?
That doesn't mean it's their idea. Like, but like the people that wrote the fiction, it's their ideas.
Okay, but they bought it.
Well, yeah, the thing is, under the law, if I hire you to do it, it's my idea. That's how the law is written. I'm not saying it's right.
And I understand that too. But I'm okay with Robert D. owning it. But we're not talking about an individual. We're talking about a business. The business owns it. There is no individual ownership of Transformers.
Right. No, I agree with you. You know, I think it's wrong. It all comes down to the whole premise of corporations being legal entities, you know, and freedom of speech. The spending money is a form of freedom of speech for a corporation. I mean, it's like, what the fuck? I mean, some horrible shit.
It's horrible. I don't
see anything changing soon. It is.
Horrible. Okay, I got two things. I got two things I asked. Did anybody watch the Cabana Wars today?
Yes, I did.
I did not.
Okay. It's pretty good.
I saw it.
Optimus and Wingblade.
That was stupid.
Do you think they? I feel like that one person is it's their job to. Dumb. Okay,
you hey, Robert, shut
the
up.
The two of you can't talk at the same time.
Go, Robert.
Two years.
I'm just making it up. It's like, oh, go ahead.
Yeah, we know. So shut up. Okay, cool. What was you gonna say, Lenny?
I was gonna say I feel like two different people are working. Like one person's working on animating Wingblade, and one is working on animating Optimus because. Windblade looked so much better and was animated so much better, and Optimus was just kind of like.
Did you see the way he's dodging and stuff? It's like, yeah, it was weird. Like
it was
dumb.
It was completely
the Matrix
dumb.
And shit. Like, I'm just like, no, and Windblade
they
is
weren't
just
even
moving
showing
so
it.
Smooth.
It's just like every time they'd just show Windblade's sword hitting the ground. I'm just like, come
and it felt like I'm like, she could have hit Prime several times
easily.
It was just like he was like, and like she's moving really, you know, gracefully, you know, a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I see what you're saying and everything. And her voice is good. Optimus' voice, I don't know.
I thought it was okay. I thought
it's all right, but it's, you know, it's fine. It's fine. I mean,
it has the pacing of Dragon Ball Z. Like, it's just. We're only getting 5 minutes per episode, and they're showing us a fucking 30-second fight over 5 minutes. Come on.
I wanted more. I wanted more. When that one got done, I was like, yeah.
That's because nothing happened.
I don't know. I mean, I'm kind of digging it. It's okay. It's not great, but it's okay. You know.
So you have to download their app to watch this, right?
No, you can see it on Facebook. You can just watch it from Facebook. Someone will post it up there.
Or YouTube.
Or YouTube. You can watch
it. I can't find it on YouTube.
Me too.
You can't find Machinima on YouTube?
I can find Machinima, but it's not airing on the Machinima on my YouTube app.
It's all the previews.
Yep.
Maybe it's an Australian thing then.
YouTube down under.
I just watch it on Facebook. I got another question, and I think we should do this probably. Does anybody have a favorite Transformer of the week? Or anybody playing with stuff that, you know, a Transformer you normally don't? Play with, or you just, you know, have a favorite one? I think it'd be pretty cool if we do that.
Well, you collect toys, and we all collect collectibles. So.
Oh, okay, so that's just me then. Okay,
I got my Fembots out. I got my Fembots out.
Did you like it?
MMC. Yeah, I like them. I like them a lot.
Oh,
did you get the
Nero and the Feral ones?
Yeah, they're all out. I got my Make Toys Headmasters here, and I got some Warren Pocket figures. They're all having a fun little battle, and Scarlet comes in here every day and plays with them too. And she dropped my fucking Xerxes off my desk.
Oh,
she dropped it, and I was just like, oh my God! Like, I heard it crash.
Is it broken?
She looked no.
Oh.
Nothing broke.
Wow.
She looked terrified. I was just like, honey, it's okay. It's just plastic. I've had that conversation with her lots of times because I would feel like a really shitty dad for yelling at my kid for breaking a fucking toy because she'll always remember that. I never do that to her, you know, and I don't want her to get her values mixed up, you know. But that was, you know, I told her, I said, that's why we don't play with this one, honey. It's too expensive.
Mm.
I couldn't believe it didn't break. Yeah.
Lenny, anyway, did you? Sorry.
Yeah, I've been messing with and he's just feet at the moment, but the generation toy, Devastator. I'm really looking forward to finishing that thing off.
Cool. Bobby?
I've been messing.
Do you have
time
to even mess with anything?
Yeah, I mess. If something really tickles my fancy, I'll take a minute and really fuck with it. And SH Big Wars Ant-Man. I fucked with him a lot.
For the record, Bobby has the word fancy tattooed on his penis.
Fancy.
Wow.
Why
do you have that, Bobby?
It's fancy.
Justin, did you play with anything?
No, I haven't been doing anything. So
good talk. Good talk.
Too busy.
Good talk. Good talk.
What about you, man?
Family cookouts.
Wheelie. I've been messing around with Wheelie a lot. I know it's weird, and he's a weird character, really? And really nobody likes him. Yeah, the Titan Return ones were a $10 toy, and he's got paint on him. Like I said, like $6 worth of paint. He's a good little figure, and I've been messing around with him. Mine's tight. A lot of people have been loosey-goosey, but mine's good. I like him. He's a good little toy.
You know, speaking of which, I watched one Star Wars, theory thing on YouTube, and I'm just bombarded now with – I didn't realize how many nerds are posting YouTube videos about who the fuck is Plagueis, who is Snoke.
Oh, dude, there's a T-shirt. It's actually by an Australian guy.
Shout out to Australia.
Shout out to Australia.
Just the whole country.
Yeah.
There's only five of us.
It's a country.
The
old continent.
They had it's a T-shirt you can buy. It says your Snoke theory sucks.
Oh God! I mean, so many. I mean, honestly, all these Star Wars videos, it's really a bit forced.
Oh no, you didn't.
He was waiting to say that the whole show.
I've
been waiting to say that.
You're a cunt.
You're a cunt.
I think with that we can get out of here.
All right, shout outs to the Third Party Unlimited, at Real Robot, Toy Detox, Fear Corpse, I Am Ratchet, Third Party TF Crashes, TF Prototype, Open Your Toys Podcast, ROC, and Nerd Rage Radio.
Shout out to Adam.
Shout out. Always a shout out to Adam. This podcast is intended for mature audiences only.
Oh, wait, really quick.
Oh, okay, sorry, go. Shut the fuck up, Chip.
So wait, no. Bobby, why are we all your Secretary of Defense? All of us. Just
that was good.
And Adam's your Vice President.
Well, look, I was going off. I was just trying to shout everybody out, man, and I didn't want to make the whole fucking skit 30 minutes of shouting out names.
Shout out to Doy TikTok. Shout out to RLC. Shout out to – they're all
mine. I was trying to give a plug to everybody.
Oh, God, Robert. Man.
Go ahead, Lynn.
Grateful ass.
Feel free to turn it off now.
All right, Tucker here, wanting to comment on the Toys as Investments. You know, if you are prospecting the market, you have lost your mind. Like, there is no time in history, except for a few times, where it ever made sense to be into collectibles. If you're buying fucking Titan War Optimus Prime, expecting it to double in value, I have to ask you, man, where is your decision making? What does your credit score look like? What does your credit cards look like? What does your kids' college tuition look like? Because there's only been a few times where it made any sense to be into collectibles, and basically it was those times when nobody knew any better. You look at the people that made it crazy rich, it was when comics were being produced by the millions, and I mean print runs, like Action Comics. How many Action Comics number one were printed? But the thing is that nobody was collecting them. They were literally pulp. They were printed as pulp, to be consumed and thrown away. Nowadays, comics have smaller and smaller print runs, but 99% of that print run is sold in comic boards and Mylar bags and immediately go into a nerd basement, climate controlled, and are just preserved. The same thing with toys. You know, you have the early toys that didn't have fiction and connected with them, and so didn't have that heart that made them blow up in the 80s. You know, there's not going to be many other He-Mans. There's not going to be many other G1 Transformers. One, because they're just redoing everything. And two, it's not the same idea of consumption. When Transformers came out, toys were for kids. They were opened. They were played with. And that was the end of it. Nowadays, Transformers are for adults. As many that are sold to be open are either A, opened and put on a pristine shelf, or B, unopened and saved. You know, Bobby Skullface himself said, I'll get an extra RC. I'll leave it in box. Maybe I'll sell it down the line. That's what's happening nowadays. There's too many collectors collecting sealed items, and there's too many collectors investing. And that's obviously just going to kill the market for anything. You know, this current Deadpool scam, like that's Deadpool's only going to retain value till the next Deadpool. And anything in that much demand, they're going to redo. None of these toys are going to be made and then thrown away. It's not like Takara in the 70s and 80s when they made a toy and they thought they were making it for that year. Like, you have lost your mind if you think that Takara didn't make a number of extra copies for all of their Optimus Primes from the movie. They're going to re-release that crap on the 5th anniversary, the 10th anniversary, the 20th anniversary, the 7th anniversary. They're going to re-release that every time they think they can make a dollar. Every mold they have, they're going to treat like it's gold because now they realize that they're in this crap for 40 years. And if you don't see that, I don't know what's up with you. Same thing with third party. You know, we're all not going to make the Greg for Mercy decision to sell our Quake Wave the week before they announce 4 new versions. Most of the time, you're going to choose wrong, and most of the time, something is going to be made again. You know, we're on the umpteenth version of Red Alert. We're getting Toon Red Alert. We're on the 4th, 5th, 6th re-release of MP10. Anything they have that they think they can make a dollar on is coming back. And third party's the same. They're not getting out of these things like they were, and not as many companies are falling to the wayside. You know, I was trying to find a Sun Surge, and I can't find one for any kind of reasonable price. Well, guess what? They've already announced that they're doing another run. So, I'm just saying, make some more sound decisions, because if you're investing and investing across the line, that's not going to work out for you in the end.
Shut the fuck up, Chip.
All right, Shattercast, this is Tucker with another dispatch. I heard y'all were running out of questions, so I have to share this with you as a lead-in to my question. Recently, I bought a Diaclone Fortress X. If you've ever priced one of those, that is not a purchase for the faint of heart. And I got it, and it was appropriately shipped, wrapped in bubble wrap, into a box. That box was wrapped in bubble wrap. That was then placed into another box, and then shipped internationally. Despite the seller's careful arrangements, the head ended up broken in no less than 4 places. And so I was incredibly disappointed. And then, of course, the seller said he would accept the return, but requested I do it on the cheapest shipping, which, of course, would not cover the appropriate insurance, and didn't want me to declare the full customs value. And that's kind of a nightmare. So my question, what is your absolute worst shipping story? And or what is your absolute worst eBay story?
Shut the fuck up, Robert.